There you go.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This first board budget committee meeting on the 2017 budget figures is called to order at 7 p.m. Please rise to the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. If the members of the committee will please introduce yourselves to the public, starting on the viewer's right with Mrs. Bridal Russell.
Jenny Bridal, Hampton School Board Representative. Gina Barnes, Board of Selectmen Representative.
Michael Pierce.
Ray Kravitz.
Brian Lopham.
Steve Henderson.
Mike Wolf.
Stephen LaBranche. Bob Ladd, Village District Representative.
David Mora.
Danielle Augustine.
Good. Thank you very much. The first thing we need to do is have a discussion and a vote on our new secretary. Eileen Latimer is so overwhelmed with work that she has told me that she can no longer do the minutes for us. She pinch hit for us for a couple of meetings, but we need a secretary. So Barbara Kravitz has volunteered. She is certainly experienced. And I believe all of you should have received my email with Barbara's description of her expertise and so forth. So what I will do is accept a motion to make her our secretary and second, and then we'll call Barbara up to talk with us for a few minutes. You can ask her questions if you wish, and then we can proceed with the meeting. Yes, sir?
I noticed in the email that you had... she requested a certain amount of money.
Well, that's what we're going to discuss.
Okay.
That's what we're going to discuss. Okay, so if I may have a motion
make
to...
Make that motion.
Mr. LaBranche will move.
Second.
Okay, and Mr. Lapham seconded. Barbara, why don't you come up, my dear, and bring your huge pile of... and then... There we go. And if you ladies and gentlemen have questions.
I have a question.
Yep.
I'll let her get up here.
That's what I was. Yeah. Okay.
Wait, Mike.
They're doing the library and then.
We're going to conclude our decision on a secretary.
I understand. Are we doing the library tonight?
Yes.
Librarian.
Yes.
That isn't in general government. That's the library. That's why I asked.
Yes, I know, my dear.
Mosquitoes
aren't...
I'm not being fussy, but you didn't say we're covering a library in addition to general government.
Okay. All right.
So, I'm being fussy.
So the question.
Question for
Barbara. Here's the question. First of all, I have two questions.
Hey, no noise.
Are you going to attend our meetings or take the minutes from the audio?
Here.
You're going to be here.
Okay.
And then the second question or comment I have to make is that I noticed that you requested a certain amount of money, but... We only budgeted a certain amount.
Mm-hmm.
And so how are you planning to take care of that?
Well, that's up to the pleasure of the committee.
Okay.
Our normal payment for secretarial services, and as I mentioned to Barbara, is $125 per meeting. I noticed that the town is paying $150, I believe, and school as well, Ginny? Yeah. So we do have room in our budget because we've shortened out a couple of meetings here. So it's up to the pleasure of the committee.
I'm just wondering where we are with money. Do we have enough money to
do this?
Yes,
we do.
We certainly don't want to go over, as a budget committee, I don't think we want to go over our budget.
Well, we've already missed, two or three meetings because the budgets weren't ready.
Okay,
so.
That's true. Now, the thing is that... there is the amount to pay for a recording secretary. There's also some money in there for some training.
Yeah.
I think there was $300.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Am I correct on that? Right. So if we had to, we could use that money as well. So
but that is pretty much the going rate for the town at the moment. And the other advantage, I think, because I much prefer to have the secretary present. It resolves any problems with I couldn't see who voted for what or whatever. So it should be a matter of just straight doing the minutes from here.
I agree with you completely. I just wonder if one thing that we might consider is that this isn't a lifetime appointment. For instance, I'm just wondering if every year after, perhaps when we reorganize after the elections, it should be at least posted, the job, see at least once a year, so that it's not as it has been in the past. It seems like it's a lifetime appointment with no opportunity for somebody else to come along.
Joan Rice served, God bless her, for many years as secretary to the Budget Committee. She had tremendous expertise, and that was a godsend. And as I told you in my email, good qualified secretaries are as scarce as hen's teeth. And so an opportunity to have a good qualified secretary cheers me up.
I agree.
Any questions for Barbara? Any further comments?
Well, what is the agreed on price then?
Well, then Steve has brought that up. So do you want to make...
You said $150 is the going price.
That's for the school.
I
would have to make a motion for $150. Is that going to be something acceptable to you?
Not my preference.
Well, that's my motion at the moment.
Barbara had mentioned that she'd like to be paid by the hour, but traditionally what we do is pay per meeting. So,
I will second.
Okay, then. Mr. LaBranche has moved, and Mr. Lapham has seconded, offering $150 per meeting.
Per meeting. And understand that, for instance, the last meeting only was 1 hour. And you'd still get $150.
She still has to go home and type it out.
Well, I know, but I'm just saying that they're not all three-hour meetings.
Right.
So.
And we're going to be fast and frugal this evening.
We are. We'll make it. And then next year when we do our budget for next year, we can add a little more if that's, satisfactory. It's just that I don't want to see us going over it. And I didn't do the math. Has anybody here done the math? Do we actually have enough money? With the projected amount of meetings we're supposed to have, is there enough money to do it?
Yes, we will. We added the 2,000 to the bottom line for the legal.
And we've already missed three meetings or whatever. Yeah.
So 300. So is there enough money to give her 175?
No.
Okay. We have enough for 150.
Okay.
Yeah. So
all
that's
right.
The number.
A vote on the amendment to the motion as far as the money is. We're not going to spend all night on this. We got a huge pile of work to do here.
I don't want to vote on it.
That's all right. I understand that, and I appreciate it. All right, so a show of hands on the amendment regarding the pay, the compensation per meeting for the secretary. Hello? Okay. Everyone is in agreement except for Mr. Kravitz, who is abstaining. Okay, now a vote on the primary motion to make Mrs. Kravitz our secretary, at least until she says, good heavens, I can't do it anymore. But for the time being, she's rescuing us. Well, I mean, Okay, in favor of the main motion to ask Mrs. Kravitz to serve as our secretary. Okay, unanimous with the exception of Mr. Kravitz, who is abstaining. Well, we lived through that, Barbara.
Thank you.
Okay, now, in an effort to not go forward for the next 15 hours, I'm going to do something a little different this year. We're going to start with some of the quick accounts, and then we can fight over the big pieces later. What I'm going to do is start with the executive first, and Christy did a wonderful job giving us tabs. The tabs make it much easier to follow. So go to executive first for us, please. And we're going to look at two accounts here. The first is Board of Selectmen. This hasn't changed in my memory. $15,000 for the year. That's $3,000 times 5 selectmen for the year. Plus the supplies and expenses account, which is $1,300, which is for flowers or condolence cards or some such that the selectmen may need to do. What?
Trips to Concord.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So the motion is going to be, Mr. Pierce making the motion.
Sure.
For 4130 executive, $16,300 for 2017.
I'll second that.
Seconded by Mr. LaBranch. Okay, all in favor? Very nice. Next on the same page, trustees of the trust funds, account 41305.
Mary Louise.
Yes, sir?
I didn't get a chance to vote.
I'm sorry?
I voted no.
You voted? I'm sorry. I get so used to you voting yes. But thank you. All right, Mr. Lapham has said no. And you were all right on that, Sonny?
No.
Okay.
I joined with
Mike. Oh, you joined him. Okay, so we have two no, and everyone else said yes. Thank you. Okay, trustees of the trust funds. They are requesting $310,937. That's part-time wages and supplies and expenses. Do I have a motion for the trustees of the trust?
Mary Louise?
We should do in the bottom line.
Yeah.
They'd be ecstatic
if you gave. Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, my goodness. It's a good thing I've got all of you here.
See? They would love that.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
they would have a good time with all that. $570 for wages, $430 for supplies and expenses. I should have brought my ruler. For a total of $1,000 for the trustees.
I'll move that.
Mr. LaBranch moves. Mr. Henderson seconds. You understand that intent?
Mm-hmm.
In favor? Unanimous. Thank you. Okay. Moving right along. Oh, bless your heart. Look at that. Between all of us. Second is conservation. Jay? You've got your tabs here, so find conservation. We're going to do fast forward here.
For me.
It's in the back. Find your conservation tab. Conservation Commission is requesting, and I'm going to read the right line so I don't get Mr. Pluff upset. We're looking at $35,525. Is that acceptable and correct and all that good stuff?
It's acceptable, correct, and all that good stuff.
Okay. May I have a motion, and then we'll ask Mr. Diener to explain, or you guys can question him. Moved by Mr. LaBranch, seconded by Mr. Henderson. Good evening, Mr. Diener and Rayanne.
Good evening.
All right. Do you want to discuss, explain, tell us anything about your budget for next year for conservation?
Sure. Let me just quickly take you through some of the changes. But before I do that, I'm here in place of Barbara Renault, who is our chairman of the Conservation Commission. She's also supervisor of the checklist. She's had a little bit of a busy week this week.
Yeah.
So Rayanne, our conservation coordinator, and I are here to answer all your questions. I'll walk you quickly through the changes. Going down the roster, we are asking for a 2% salary increase for our conservation coordinator, which is the same rate that other non-union town employees are being requested for this year. Probably the biggest change is we're asking for $1,500 for easement monitoring. And let me just take a moment to explain that a little bit. The town has approximately 1,500 properties that are protected properties, and it's the job of the Conservation Commission to be monitoring those properties. With our one part-time employee and a volunteer commission, we just don't have the time to do that. This year, we secured a grant through Rianne's good work from the Davis Foundation to do easement monitoring. And we hired a UNH grad student who came in during the summer. He walked or paddled over 40 properties, wrote a report on each one, photo documented what he saw on each of the properties. We can't get administrative grants like that year after year after year after year. So we're asking to increase our budget so that we can hire an intern each summer to do the same amount, approximately the same amount of monitoring. And we figure if we can cover about 40 properties each year, then every 3 or 4 years, each property throughout the town will be visited and recorded.
Excellent, because it's important to monitor the town property like that. Now, conservation commissioners are not paid, so the wages that you see here are for the student or whoever is doing the monitoring of the conservation lands, and for Rayanne, who's the conservation coordinator.
And the secretary.
And the secretary. So that's all included in the $32,645?
That's correct.
Excellent. Okay. And your bottom line is $35,525?
Correct.
Okay. Anybody have any questions for Jay and Rayanne? And they do a terrific job. They really do. Okay. Are you ready now? Let's see. You gentlemen made the motion already.
Motion, Steve.
Okay. Are you ready to take the vote on conservation?
Yes.
$35,525 for 2017. Mm-hmm. In favor? David?
Yes,
unanimous. Thank you so much for coming in.
Thank you for inviting us.
All right. Next is going to be cemetery. Is Mr. Kenny?
Okay.
We're going through the small, sort of non-controversial stuff.
Cemeteries.
Mr. Kenny, sir, good evening.
Hi, Mrs. Madam Chairman.
Yes, sir?
Thank you so much.
All right.
I'm making this city over 3 hours.
Cemeteries.
Yes, ma'am.
We're showing wait a minute. I've got to get the right. There we go. $124,143. Mm-hmm. That you are requesting for 2017. And we've got the breakdown. Anyone want to move that amount forward? Mr. LaBranche and Mr. Henderson. Okay, Mr. Kenny is here. Ask him questions. Danny, do you want to make a statement first?
I just want to say quickly, I believe this is my 28th year doing this. And in those 28 years, I believe it was 1996, one member voted against my budget. Other than that, I think I've been unique. So we don't want to break any trends tonight.
No, we don't.
And I do want to say very, on a more serious note, Mary Louise, quickly if I may, I so much miss Charlotte Preston. She was a trustee for a number of years, but even after, she was probably one of the very few people I could call and would actually listen to, because she always gave it to me straight, whether I liked it or not, and I loved her very much, and I miss her.
I think we all miss her, Danny. But we've grown accustomed to your face, so here you are. Tell us highlights or what you're doing with the upcoming budget.
We basically hope to continue doing what we do, and we have always the same challenges. They really haven't changed much from year to year. As you know, I always mention there are things that...
Forward a little bit so the microphone can get
I'm
you.
I'm sorry.
You're only up
1.37%. Yeah, well, you know, I always use a pretty basic formula, Mary Louise. I simply look at where I am at the end of June this year, and I just project out and then add a little for what I think, you know, will mm-hmm. be an inflation, if you will. And I think I got a better idea because, as you know, the building was renovated a few years ago, and that's kind of made utilities a little hard to predict. I think now I got a better handle on that than I have in the past. So we'll see. I always, you know, we like to do a lot more things than we do. We're very, we take a lot of pride in our cemetery and
good.
Giving people peace when they come to visit. That's what it's all about.
Any questions for Danny while he's here?
I noticed your actual is $120,416, mm-hmm. and you're going up.
Mm-hmm. That was you for 2015.
More business, huh?
Excuse
Sonny,
me?
Sonny, that was 2015.
Yeah, I realized that was the actual for last year.
Yeah.
Yeah, so he's going, he expect more business.
Perhaps.
Never can tell. Anybody else have questions for Danny? I have one thing to notice that struck me as soon as I picked up the book and started going through it, and it's in your budget too. Look at gasoline.
Yes, that's right. Yeah.
And I almost had a heart attack when I started going through the budget and saw the gasoline lines. Now, we'll address that as a lump sum because we found mm-hmm. that in Ollie, but it's up 66.93% for gasoline. And I know that's not something that you can control, but we just want to point that out because that kind of made me say, ah, but you can't. That's the budget. So we'll address that later on.
Who's to say on that? Yeah. Certainly not I.
You can't.
Now, assuming that adjustments will be made, and we can go back on our final review, assuming that adjustments will be made to gasoline lines, or at least we'll get an explanation, are you prepared to vote on the proposed? Mr. Pierce?
No, I have a question.
Okay, you have a question too? All right.
Yes, the actual on the gasoline that you brought up so nicely is only $1,068, and they want $37.43. The math just doesn't even begin to work there. That's nearly three times as much, at least two times as much, as what it's going to be projected to the end of the year. So the gallons are seriously wrong, or the price of gas is seriously wrong, or both.
Yeah.
This is the worst case of any of them in the budget book.
Hold on. Hold on a second. First of all, that gas line also includes oil.
Oh, heating oil?
As well. No, oil
that engine goes,
Engine oil. Engine oil for all our machines.
But it's not just your budget. This, the gasoline, quote, gasoline line is showing really high in all of the...
Well, yeah. And
it's nothing you could...
Did any of us expect... We could very easily be paying $5 a gallon a year.
Yeah, but we're not.
I understand.
$2.08 at most.
Well,
so.
I mean, he's talking about math. Give me the equation.
We're going to address it, Danny, as a whole, because it's showing all
Well, he's
the
saying
budgets.
I'm the worst. I'm just trying to put a few things in perspective for him.
As far as the gasoline goes, are you locked in with the state, or are you
doing
like everyone else is? And
we're about Hess. Hess, yeah.
Okay.
Yes, we are.
We'll still, we will be focusing on that, though, when we talk to the manager.
Yes, but... what Mike was trying to say, I think, is these numbers just don't add up.
Right.
Can I make a point of order?
And we can't predict the future.
Okay, point of order?
Yes.
Are you going to make a motion to change the number?
Well, I'd like to know from the... Who calculated this number, if it was Christie or if it was our gentleman here we're talking to, because it doesn't make any sense the way it is. I'd like somebody to explain how you got up to 37.43.
Okay, let's get Christy or Fred, because we might as well head it off at the pass, because all of the gasoline lines made us go eek.
Okay, so first I'll point out, if you look at the detail page, the gasoline line for this particular department, as Danny has stated, does include fuel for a equipment. It says mowers and equipment, and that is he himself has budgeted $1,500 for that line, or that portion of the gasoline line. Across the whole budget for all gasoline accounts, we are using WEX. No one is using the state anymore. All departments are using the WEX card, which allows them to go to the pump and not have to go through the process of filing to get your taxes back, as had to be done in previous years. This program allows them to go right to the pump, and the tax is taken off before it's billed to the town on a monthly basis. So what we've done is we've budgeted across the board $1.95 a gallon. We've looked at the average that we've been paying. And then, so on Danny Kenny's budget, it says cemetery truck based on 1,150 gallons at $1.95. So his gasoline for his vehicle is coming out to $2,243. I have been monitoring gasoline. I have a spreadsheet that has started, and so I projected out what I believed would be used. I had numbers through the end of September, and so every gasoline and diesel line throughout the entire budget, if you look at the actual use, like he said, he has other items in here. So his $1,500, is that high? I don't know. I don't monitor that. But I can tell you that looking at the gallons that he's used, that as of the end of September, if you project out what he's used and multiply it, divide it by 9, multiply it by 12, you come to 1,150 gallons, and that's how that number is in there. We have been looking, we do it at the end of each month. We've been doing it since July and brought them to the board. We've adjusted it a couple times at the Board of Selectmen's level, too. So that's how the gasoline and diesel was calculated for vehicle use throughout the budget.
There you go.
So So you're calculating it as a dollar and what?
95 cents.
$1.95.
For unleaded, and the diesel is at 235, I believe.
I know the diesel is higher.
Yeah.
That seems like a heck of a jump, though. I'm still...
The $1.95 and the... 235 are the numbers that we used last year. We also looked back and saw what we've priced out, what we've used, been charged this year, and it's still right there with the, very close to that $1.95. It might have been a little bit lower, but you don't know what is going to happen with the price. I think you guys are really caught up here, but I think you need to look at the detail line there and see maybe he's not using the whole 1500 for mowers and equipment. I don't know because I don't monitor that, but I can assure you that he is close to the $11.50 for the gallons.
But it's after summer. You're 9 months on. You've got your figure right here, the actual, as of the end of September, $1,068.
Right.
So divide that by three and tack on another 3 months, and you're not doing as much mowing and whatever
in
the cemetery.
No, but you could be doing snow plowing and stuff.
Snow plowing? Yeah,
it is two trucks, by the way.
Okay.
Yeah, no.
Yes.
So...
I still think that's a heck of a jump from 2242 to 3743, but
that's
me.
Humongous, yes.
Well, I won't spend more than I need. I never have.
It's not. Yeah, this is generic, Danny. This is the
I understand.
This is your calculation for all of the gasoline and diesel for the whole.
Yeah. I might just say
right.
Go ahead.
Can I make a suggestion?
Yes.
Yeah. You know, these are preliminary numbers. Once we get in through the process, we'll have a better idea of what's
right.
involved.
Because we will have a final review.
So,
okay.
One of the clinchers for me on this is that 2240.
Make sure you guys are talking into the microphone. When I watch some of the budget committee reruns from home, sometimes I can't hear you. Get the microphones where you can be heard. They've got a microphone right there.
I don't know. How can I tell if they hear me? I have no way of knowing.
Go ahead.
But back to this 2242 for 16, and you spent roughly half of that, and we're three quarters of the way through the year. And so 2242 will probably amply cover the what you're going to have for 16, but you're asking for another $1,500 on top of that.
Yeah.
That's way out in my mind. We can come back later on this, but that's just kind of hard to believe.
Yeah.
We will do a final review.
We're not questioning the way you processed it. I'm saying comparing the numbers right here on this sheet, right here in black and white, you haven't spent half of your budget for this year, and yet you want to take the budget amount for this year and almost at least 1.5 times it to get to that 3743.
Well, one thing I might say to address that, I don't know if it's perfect. Snow plowing was mentioned. Last year we did very little. The year before we were out doing it pretty much every day. So I'm looking at that as well.
Brian has a question or...
Hate to harp on this, but I'm still a little confused.
Okay.
What are you spending the gasoline money on?
It's used
apparently it's not just gasoline.
Both our trucks, all our mowers, our weed whackers, our power saws.
Are you replacing them?
Replacing the machines?
Yes.
Sure.
Yes.
Or anything like that?
Not all of them, but, you know, I have 5 mowers. I have 6 weed whackers. I have 3 saws, a chainsaw.
Oh, that's what I was getting to.
All of these things need gas and oil.
Yeah.
But you're not replacing equipment
trucks.
With this front.
Out of that account?
No, I'm not.
Right, it's just strictly gas, oil.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Fuel.
That's all. Fuel, yes.
Okay. Everybody sufficiently comfortable to forward the account as is, and we will go back on everything that says gasoline for the final review.
Okay.
Okay? Prepared to vote with that little caveat on the gasoline. Thank you, Christy. In favor of the cemetery budget, which is showing for 2017, which is showing as $124,143. Unanimous. Okay, thank you very much, Danny.
Record unbroken.
Thank you all.
Mosquitoes and Kaiser. Everybody find the mosquitoes. Mosquito control. It's a yellow tab.
Here they are.
Good evening, Ann.
Good evening.
Ann Kaiser, who is helping us. There it is. All right, Ann's huge monster budget. To take care of the mosquitoes.
I'll move.
Okay, you'll move what amount?
I believe it's 166,943.
No, that's the total of Health and Human Services.
Oh, my goodness.
She'd be happy to take it.
How about 103,250?
Seconded?
Second.
Regina is seconding. Okay, Ann, talk mosquito.
2017 will be our second year of a three-year contract, so right. That figure is going to remain the same for the 3 years. It was 2016, 2017, and 2018.
Okay. And you're talking the contract for spraying? Is that
right, for mosquito control.
And we had, since it was so dry this summer, I didn't hear the mosquito spraying going by too much.
They came by almost every week. Actually, starting in at the end of June. They like to hit it before the 4th of July celebrations. Yeah. And then they were actually out quite a bit, but they didn't have to do as much larviciding because right. There weren't, except for the marsh, there weren't that many freshwater breeding sites.
We thank you for what you do. Does anyone have questions for Ann? Okay.
I just have one quick one, I hope. As far as the storage, is there any chance anything's going to leak where you're only using a tent to cover these?
That's for the greenhead fly traps. Yeah. We bought a tent in 2006, and we did a lot of propping up this past summer to get it so that it could be serviceable for this coming winter. That's just to store the greenhead fly traps during the winter time so that they don't suffer as much damage as they used to when they were exposed to the elements.
Good.
We don't have room in that tent actually for all of the traps that we do have, but we're working with Public Works and trying to get another more permanent structure.
Excellent.
Further? But there's no chance that anything's going to leak out of any containers or anything like that?
No containers in that tent.
Okay.
Those are all stored at our contractor's big building over in Brentwood. No, that has no chemicals.
Okay, excellent. Thank you.
The only thing
we
have is some dead greenhead flies.
Okay. Are you ready for the vote on the mosquito control bottom line, $103,250? Unanimous. Thank you.
There you go.
You're welcome. A pleasure to see you. Welfare, is Michelle here?
Okay.
Now that's a green tab. And welfare, you have two sections, administration and direct assistance. The bottom line is showing $61,705.
I'll move that.
Mr. LaBranche is moving, seconded by Mr. Pierce. Okay, Michelle, talk to us.
Well, we're seeing an increase in homeless families in the summertime when it costs between $800 and $1,200 a week to keep them housed.
Wow.
And so that's the biggest change in the budget, is increasing that.
Yeah, if you look at the bottom line, where it says public assistance rent.
Yeah, that's rent. It's the rent line.
That's the big one, $21,500.
And that's where the increase is for the year.
Could I ask a question?
Yes, just make sure we can hear you, my dear, because you speak so delicately and softly. Okay, Steve, go ahead.
I just want to point out that I believe last year we discussed as a committee that this number is what it is. Whatever she needs, she has to pay it.
Yeah.
That's it by law. Yeah. So I don't know if we really need to discuss this any further.
Okay. I just want to make sure that you guys are on. Mr. Pierce?
I do have a question about the default budget. This is not a contracted service, so how do we get that in the default budget to 21,500? That's a question probably more for Christy.
Christy?
It's mandated. I believe it was put in the default budget because, like Mr. LaBranche pointed out, it's not something that, I mean, she has to pay it, so if we use those guidelines when we put it in the default, I'm just trying to find my default, make sure it's in there.
But the criteria for being in the default budget is something that's contracted, not necessarily something may go up or may go down, like postage or gasoline. You can't put those over in the default budget either. It changes because you don't have to buy the gas, you don't have to buy the postage. Same with this. You don't have to spend money on this.
You do. By law, you do.
I understand that. It doesn't say that it has to come out, that this has to be put in the default budget. That's where it's wrong. Incorrect to be in the default budget.
The 2016 budget had $11,500.
Right. That should be what's in the default budget.
We're already over that in September.
That's right.
I expect to continue to go over until the end of the year.
And that's why you're asking for more money. I understand
that's right.
All that.
It's for your planning purposes.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Right.
I understand
that. We understand that.
And you've got about $14,000 spent already this year, which I understand all that. I'm not debating that with you. I'm just saying this number does not belong in the default budget like that. It should be what's actually in the budget. Okay?
Yeah, the default budget is predicated on the 2016 figures, Christy?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So it shouldn't be that. That should be $11.50 in the default budget line. I have no disagreement with asking for money, and I know the state law says we have to pay it. That's not the point. The point is it's not contracted, therefore it shouldn't be the default budget. There's several items that have been moved over there recently, and that's one of them.
And we can address the default budget as a whole when we get to our final review, but it's nothing that Michelle has control over. So as far as her 2017 proposed budget is concerned, we have a motion on the table for $61,705. Are you prepared to vote in favor of bringing that forward? Unanimous. Thank you very much, Michelle.
Thank you, Michelle.
Assessing, Mr. Tinker, sir. You're getting a lot of exercise finding people in your book. Yeah. Good evening.
Good evening.
Yellow tab. Okay, for 2017 assessing. Whoops.
Okay.
Is showing as a bottom line request of $287,501.
I'll move that.
Mr. LaBranche has moved, and Mr. Henderson has seconded. All right, talk to us, Ed.
Okay, the budget overall is a reduction of 11.39%. As you know, we just completed a revaluation. We had a temporary position that was funded through a warrant article, or at least approved through a warrant article. So the income, or the regular wage line reduced by $35,434.
Yeah, the young man who was helping was a contract employee.
Right. Actually left early this year, was finished up in August.
Excellent.
The next line, mapping, account 3301, $700 increase, and those are contractual figures. Data processing, same thing. The vision software maintenance increased by $160. That's the only increase in that line item.
Mm-hmm.
Under supplies and expenses, of course, we reduced the data collection supply line by $500 now that we only have one person in the office doing field work. Slight increase to the MLS listing service, and the contracted service line, $3,300, stayed the same. It's $100,000. That'll be, although some years not used, and we've discussed this before, that'll be an important line item as a result of the revaluation and what appeals may go forward in the next 5 years before the next reval or whenever that next reval is done. Motor vehicle allowance, again, because we don't have that second field person, we were able to bring that line item back down to $2,000 for a reduction of $1,900 for the two net, and that gives us the total that you spoke of.
And Ed, you wanted to mention something about the regular wages and the pay raise?
I'm good.
You're
I'm
all good. Set? Yeah, all set. Okay, good. And you will notice, ladies and gentlemen, that if you look on the default budget for mapping for Ed, that is showing as the $8,600 for the 2016 budget.
Correct, yeah.
So that figure is carried forward properly into the default. Okay, do you have questions for our assessing officer, Mr. Pierce?
Yes, I'm a little curious. Can you explain briefly for us again about how you got...
I can't hear you, Michael.
Can you explain again to us briefly about the 138.40 for the regular wages, how you got that minus 21.54?
Well, in 16, our total regular wages, or I shouldn't say just regular wages, that includes a part-time clerk. We have an assessing clerk. Mm-hmm. So the total budget for myself, the assessor assistant, the part-time clerk, and the temporary data collector was $197.78. This year's, again, regular wages are $130,840. So that's a reduction of $35,434. But that's for all positions, including the part-time.
Okay.
No, actually, yeah, if you add up the two, the way the budget's broken out, it has them separate. But if you add up the two, it's $155,344. If you added up the two last year, it's $190,778.
And which two items are you putting together real quick?
Regular wage and part-time wage.
Okay.
Any further questions for Mr. Tinker? All right.
I have, nope.
Oh,
sorry.
You have a question?
According to my notes, this is the mapping is split between four groups.
What?
Well, they're different items that they maintain for us during the year. You mean break out the way it is in under the...
Yeah, well, 40% from assessing, 40% for building.
You're losing me, Brian.
No, the assessing department maintains all the mapping, the online GIS mapping. We pay for that out of assessing, but it's available to everybody, including the public. It's an online GIS system.
Okay.
Is that what you mean? Yeah, we pay for that, though. We pay for the mapping.
And that is shared.
That's the 9300.
Yeah.
It includes the GIS online, which had an increase this year of $600.
I'll come back to this because I know it's a 40-40-10.
He's talking about a copier that is in a different budget. It's in the building,
no, it's
the
not
planning,
me.
The zoning.
Okay, so that's
no,
totally different from this. Okay.
Yeah, if you look at data processing account for me, I have my own copy and laser printer line items to take care of my stuff. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you for answering that.
Yep.
Jenny,
how did one employee get a 5% raise and another employee get a 10% raise? Is that based
nobody,
on merit?
Nobody did get those.
Oh,
raises.
They were removed. Okay.
They were removed.
Okay. They were suggested.
Well, they were actually 3% and 8%. They were suggested, but we're not granted.
Okay. Prepare for a vote on the assessing budget. 287,501 for the year 2017. Unanimous. Thank you, sir.
Yep, thank you.
Okay.
Have
tax
a safe
collector.
Home, Ed.
Tax collector is Donna here?
Yep.
There she is. Good evening. Okay.
Okay, where are we?
Good evening. Tax. It's a green tab. And Mrs. Bennett is here to cheer us up.
Well, the bills went out, so maybe not so much.
Donna, I'm seeing for your request for 2017, a bottom line of $103,997, 1.39% up from the current year.
I'll move.
Mr. LaBranche is moving, and Mr. Pluff seconded. All right, talk to us.
Well, my budget is pretty small as far as the number of line items, so it's pretty quick. Six line items, two stayed the same, two went down, and the two that went up were due to wages. One is a contractual, and the other is the elected official 3% increase that I did put in for that. The total that the budget is up is $1,424.
Questions for the tax collector? We all want to ask you to be good to us, of course, but everybody all set with Donna's figures?
Yep.
Jenny, you're frowning.
Well, no, I'm not frowning, but don't we approve the tax collector's salary in the warrant article?
No.
No.
Oh, it's just approving you?
In the old days,
we don't do that anymore.
The town clerk put in a separate warrant article just for the raise differential last year, and that went down, so... But the tax collector, the independent elected officials, as far as I'm concerned, do have a right to request their salary, and then the employees and the staff in their office. But I don't think the selectmen have the right to, and I think it would be iffy if the budget committee interfered just in the elected officials' raises. Mr. Pierce?
Would you explain the 4.93 increase in regular wages?
Part-time? Regular
wages.
That is a, she has a contractual $1,000 reimbursement for having a bachelor's degree. It's part of the union agreement.
I didn't think the union agreement
Teamsters?
Was in effect this year.
Oh, I don't know.
Not for the Teamsters.
I think the voters didn't approve it.
The Teamsters Union contract was not approved this year, right?
No, but the $1,000 has been in their contract for a while.
It's the raise.
Your deputy was up full time before, correct?
Well, this
and
last year.
And then you didn't know the $1,000.
I didn't realize the $1,000 was coming out of my budget. So now it's in my budget as a line item, as part
and that's
of that.
Part of the Teamsters contract.
Yes,
but the Teamsters contract is not in effect. Is my point.
What? Teamsters contract.
No, they didn't approve it last March.
But it would cover all the benefits. It just doesn't cover the coal contract.
The benefits stay the same.
They don't get any steps, but they still get whatever benefits they have.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. So that's legitimate then.
Are we ready to vote on the tax collector's budget?
Yep.
And that is $103,997, up 1.39%. In favor? Unanimous? Thank you, my dear, very much.
Thank you
for coming in. Now, did I see Jane in the back?
Mm-hmm.
Do you want to come up? Because I was going to do your last, but I'll
like you should. I'm happy to.
We'll pop you right through now if you want to. Town clerk. And then we're going to grab Mrs. Martin. There's the town clerk. It's kind of a maroonish tab. Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening.
She's been running ragged, so we had a little email exchange a couple of days ago, but she made it. So, town clerk. Town clerk, voter registration, election administration. So you are at $237,934 for the entire function for 2017 request.
I'll move that number.
Mr. LaBranche is moving. Mr. Henderson is seconding. Okay, Jane, up 1.59% on the town clerk section, minus 17.81% on the voter registration, and minus 48.10% on the election admin. So you're looking forward to a happy, relaxing year.
Well, I'd like to think so. The part-time wages
is an increase due to the fact that this year we hired a part-time file clerk. She didn't start till mid-year, so it was budgeted for 39 weeks this year. Yeah. Next year, it obviously is a full 52 weeks, and I have to tell you, she has made a huge difference in our office. Not only is she filing, but she was responsible for putting together all of the absentee ballots for this past election. It has made a huge difference in our office. So I want to thank you for that, because
this is a mental health rehab for you.
I don't know how we did it 4 years ago. Yeah. As it is, I have been putting in, an extra 2 to 3 hours a day.
Oh, yeah.
And then some time on the weekends as well. So even with her, with all that extra help, so.
And you notice the overtime wages are down by 13.79%.
Excellent.
Any questions for the town clerk? Mr. Pierce.
I just want to make an observation. The increase in the salary, which is, a 3% increase?
For the town clerk?
Yeah.
Yes.
I'm just pointing out, if you take 3% per year for 5 years, that's 15%. But if you compound it, which it is, that's nearly 20% in 5 years. If you compare that to Social Security increases, there's no comparison. So I should have said the same thing to the tax collector, too. 3% per year at the current rate of inflation and the cost of living is pretty darn high. I'll just bring that out.
Any other questions? Brian?
Just a quick question. During the off years of the elections, has there any thought ever been given to setting some money aside?
No, she can't.
For the year?
She can't carry forward.
She can't carry forward.
Her budget is down substantially because she's coming into the
right,
later.
And that's why I was saying you wouldn't. No, it's my elbows. It was just a question.
Yeah, well, nice thought.
And are we still up there on our voting booths? Because I know this came up a year or two ago.
We buy new voting booths every year to replace the old ones.
Okay. That's all I have. Thanks,
Jenny. Yeah,
Jane. How much is your department bring in a year?
$3 million.
Right. So really,
$3 million. Yeah,
$236,000 is kind of a bargain.
Yeah, this certainly is a revenue-generating operation. Any further questions for the town clerk?
I just have a comment. I thought you handled the election extraordinarily well. It was a record vote.
Yeah.
Many towns and areas had long waits and long lines. And if you didn't get there at 7 in the morning, that was the only time you had to wait. It really came out extremely well. You deserve
Thank you very much. We have a great team.
Mm-hmm. I was talking to the supervisors of the checklist when I was in the town office this morning, and I commended them as well. They do a great job keeping the checklist up to date. In favor of the motion that has been made for the town clerk's account, 4140, 41402, 41401, 41402, and 41403, total 237,934 for 2017. Unanimous. Thank you, my dear.
Thank you.
And Diana.
Hey, Recreation.
Rec Department. Diane Martin, good evening, my dear. There you are. And we are finding, we got you in here. Parks and Rec is a blue tab. And Diana is asking for a total of $235,610.
I'll move that.
Which is down 1.13%, moved by Mr. LaBranch, seconded by Regina Barnes. Talk to us.
Well, as you can see, there's a few things that did change. The lifeguards are gone out of the budget. That's part of the reason that it's... But there is one change that I did want to discuss with you.
A little louder so we can hear you.
There is one change that I did want to discuss with you. I was doing some numbers now that we're toward the end of the year. And this year in my parks budget, parks part of the budget, parks maintenance part of the budget,
yep.
I've already spent $17,830. And in this budget coming forward, we had cut some things out and put them in warrant articles. And so my budget now is $13,050. And this particular year, even spending this amount of money, I didn't get the playground surfacing that I had put in the budget this year. And I've already spent that part of the budget. So I was hoping that you guys might be interested in adding $5,000 back into this budget so I won't go over the budget and I can purchase that playground surfacing for the Kids Kingdom and the toddler park.
What about the 20% that you get from the receipts, the parking receipts?
Yeah, that's
how does that factor in, Diana?
That's where some of the things that were taken out of this budget went into that 20% warrant article. That's for infrastructure. So this is FIBAR, which is the surfacing for the playgrounds, which I've always considered parks maintenance.
Mm-hmm.
But like I said, I wasn't able to purchase it this year because we ended up having to make some repairs to a fence that we weren't foreseeing. So we had to spend the money there instead of getting the surfacing.
Okay, so the first 9 months of the year, and this is on the grounds and fields line, right?
Yes.
Okay. Diana was budgeted for $19,550. She has spent in the first 9 months $19,262. She requested $18,050, and of course, it was dropped down to $13,000. Question?
Okay. I know that 20% that you get from the parking lot revenue every year. Mm-hmm. You usually have something planned for that. Do you have something planned for it next year?
Yeah.
What would that
be? We put in the items that were cut out of this. Oh my God, I don't have it with me, but.
No, but usually,
I have
like
a warrant
one
article.
Year you did lighting for one of the fields.
Right.
Another time you did the building or something.
Yeah.
So I'm just wondering. And if the selectman's plan was for you to take some of that money and use it on this very line item, that's basically my question. Is that their intent, that $5,000 of that money would be put?
Yeah, it was for something else that was in this budget, and it went over to that warrant article. The warrant article has about 6 things in it. I don't have it in front of me. I shouldn't have it.
No, but I guess the question I'm asking is that, so the warrant article will put that money back in here, correct?
Well, it's a separate spending.
No, it would be purchasing something else. What I'm saying is, are you saying to put it back in the budget?
Right, what am I?
No.
Okay, that answers my question then.
Right.
So what we need is a motion. I'll make a motion to add $5,000 back into that line.
Second.
Okay, moved by Mr. LaBranch, seconded by Mr. Henderson. Further discussion.
What was the line?
Beg pardon, we're in the...
Which line are you?
6,500.
Under culture and recreation.
Grounds and fields under maintenance.
Time of recreation.
Grounds and fields, thank you.
I'm just scared of going over the budget because I need to purchase that surfacing.
So that would change the bottom line to $240,610.
So what does that change the percentage to?
Instead of being up 1.13%?
Yeah.
Yes. Selectman's number from 13050 to 18050 from the budget committee, right?
Yes.
Further questions for Diana? Prepare to vote on the amendment?
Have we gotten into that portion where the lifeguards are covered yet?
No lifeguards.
Where are they?
I don't know. They're not in this budget anymore.
This is separate.
Yes, this is separate. We're on the amendment.
That was removed from the budget?
We're on the
We're on an amendment. We're getting ready to vote on an amendment.
But they've been some, put somewhere else.
That's different. That's after this.
You happen to know where they were put?
I know.
Will you still be hiring lifeguards yourself?
Point of order.
Okay. Mr. Jones.
You're not yet charged with that.
We have a motion on the floor.
You're not yet charged with that?
Tim?
You are not yet charged with hiring the lifeguard. Someone else is?
I don't know.
Mr. Jones, they're in other safety services.
Yeah, we usually don't need one.
The lifeguards are in other safety services now.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, we've got an amendment on the floor here. Okay, in favor of the amendment to add the $5,000 to make that line $18,050. Brian Russell, Barnes, Gravitz, what are you doing, Brian?
No.
Henderson?
Clough,
LaRanch, yes, Ladd, and Maurer, and Augustine, and Woolsey. And Mr. Jones is abstaining?
Correct.
Mr. Lapham is?
Opposed.
Opposed. Pierce is opposed? Okay. Anything further for the Recreation Director?
You want to do the parking lots, too?
Yes, actually, frankly, in a minute. But that's a separate tab.
That would be under other general through
here.
Government.
No, we actually have nice tabs here, so that we can here parking admin. It's parking like admin. A maroonish kind of tab. Okay, parking. The request is $83,726 for 2017.
The only changes that are here is I have to add in $1,000 each year for the lease for the Church Street parking lot, and I also changed the seasonal wages for the parking employees this year. So I put in a true figure for that for next year, which would be the a summer like this year where we didn't have any rain, so we worked every day pretty much. So this would be the figure if we worked every single shift of the summer.
And your revenue so far this year is roughly?
It's getting close to, it's over $500,000. We have three concerts left, but
right.
Getting close to,
but it's
getting
been
up towards
significant
six.
Revenue
yeah, it's
coming
up towards
in from
six.
The parking lot. Okay, let's see. Who had the motion on parking admin?
I made the motion for her, for Parks and Recreation.
No, this is parking.
We didn't make our motion.
This is
we didn't do it yet.
Regular parking administration.
It hasn't been done yet.
So moved.
Okay, Mr. Pluff is moving the $83,726, seconded by Mr. Henderson. More questions, Mr. Pierce?
Yes, you've got the $41,376 under seasonal wages, an increase in the budget there, and you've gotten a default budget, and that's not the correct amount. It'd be $37,000 again. Another default budget, right. Line is wrong.
That's not Diana's.
I understand. I'm just bringing it
but
to
you're right.
Attention
mm-hmm.
while we're here.
Do you know what the right number is?
Yes, it should be $37,000 in the default.
No, I meant you were referring to the percentage increase was wrong, correct?
What?
Well, in the default, yes, it would be less. It should be zero in the default, but when it comes to the actual request for this year, the $41,376 would be 11.83, if that's what your question is.
Okay. But we'll check
so
the default budget
default
figures
budget.
When we get the final, because that's not Diana's problem.
Oh, okay.
She's not doing the default budget. Further questions? Pay attention, gentlemen. Further questions for the Recreation Director.
So, Diana, what did you went up on your prices or the what you're paying the kids at the parking lots? Where are you now with that? I just am asking because I know that I know the Village District, we're all trying to compete with down the street. I'm not going to name names, but
my friend,
he's paying like $12 an hour. And I know that at the Village District, we had to go up a little bit to be competitive. So mm-hmm. you went from, was it $8 to?
To 10.
To 10, okay.
Yep.
So.
And I have two assistants. I have the supervisor that gets a salary, and then I have two assistants that make right now $12 an hour because they've been there for 9 or 10 years also, but they're assistants to Victor. And if they should leave, though, I think the next person coming into that position will probably be paid a little bit less.
Yes.
Like maybe 11.
Very, very reasonable, considering that they're handling so much cash and so much responsibility. So, good job.
And they have a real bathroom at Church Street.
Yes, they do.
Okay, ready for the vote on the parking admin budget proposed for 2017, $83,726.
Point of order.
Yes, sir.
The motion was to move this line item. Where are you moving it to?
What?
Yeah. Are you moving it to public hearing? Are you moving it to final review?
We're moving this to the final review.
Thank you.
And the public hearing won't come until after we're all done. Okay, in favor? Unanimous. All right. Thank you very much, Diana. Counselor, where did... Good evening, Mark.
Good evening. Wait.
What?
Could I, point of order, did we actually vote on the motion for her bottom line? I know we made a motion to add $5,000.
No, this is parking admin.
I'm talking about Parks and Recreation.
We went to Parks and Rec.
Did we?
I read the figure with the, yeah, with the 5,000.
Did we vote on that?
With the 5,000 added.
Yes.
We did vote.
Yeah, we did.
Okay, I'm just checking.
$240,610.
We did. Okay, thank you very much.
Okay. Mark, good evening.
Evening.
Find the legal tab, ladies and gentle folks. There it is, purple. All right, Mark, for 2017. I'm showing a request from you of $176,182. That includes the town attorney's office and legal expenses.
Yes.
Thank you.
This figure represents a 1.33% increase over last year's budget. The increase has come entirely in two lines. Which is the regular wages line and the part-time wages line.
Right.
And these reflect 2% cost of living increases that actually went into effect April 1 of this year. And so our office consists of two people, and I'd like to give a lot of credit to Ann Marchand, my administrative assistant, who's going on 3 years with us and has made a tremendous difference in the quality of my life and the appearance of the office, and especially in our storage order. She does a wonderful job. I'd also like to thank Christina Ostman, who assists with the drafting of the invitations to bid and the contracts that result as a result of the award of bids.
Right.
So some of her hours are spent doing that. And so it's really a team effort in terms of getting the work done here. And I thank both of them especially. Changes in terms of items between this year and last year are only really two. One of those has an increase in the of $5,000 over last year in the outside council fees, just anticipating what may be needed, and a corresponding decrease of $5,000 in the collective bargaining costs. At this point, for this year, as with last year, there is no outside council fees being spent on collective bargaining. Last year, that resulted in a savings of $35,000 to the town. And we had last year all five collective bargaining agreements were successfully negotiated. Four out of those five were approved by the town meeting. And so this year, four out of the six union contracts are being negotiated once more. In terms of what we actually do, of course, there's a lot of day-to-day work that is involved. We have approximately 20 litigation matters that are going at any one particular time. The ones that require the most attention from my office are the tax abatement cases. And as Mr. Tinker indicated, a lot of those are with our larger commercial taxpayers. Last year, we were able to successfully negotiate three of the major cases that covered a number of years. And if you compare the results from the negotiations to what was at stake, we saved approximately $700,000. That was a team effort, again, with our tax assessor, with expert input, and were successfully negotiated. Also, another one of those tax abatement cases that was actually tried in its first year and successfully defended in the subsequent years resulted in approximately $54,000 of savings. And so that's basically what's at stake. And I'm happy to answer any questions.
Okay. I'd like to make a motion first.
Yes, Mark's bottom line request for 2017.
176-182.
176-182. An increase of 1.33%. By the way, if you will...
It needs to be seconded.
Mr. Pluff seconded. Sorry about that. If you will look at the two top lines on, under Town Attorney's Office, you notice that the figure for the default budget is not correctly carried forward. That does not reflect 2016 budget. Okay, questions for counsel? Anybody have... Anybody want to Mark to represent us in a lawsuit or anything? Tim, go ahead.
Evening, Mark.
Evening.
The tax abatement litigation is funded out of the assessing department, correct?
The expenses are for the experts. That's correct.
Okay. So they're not funded out of this budget at all, so it's non-topical. Okay.
That's correct. The experts that you see are funded out of litigation expenses or for the non-tax abatement cases.
Right. Okay. And last year, this budget had an increase in the requested increase, which was ultimately denied, I think, by a 6-5 vote. An additional, I think it was $25,000?
I believe there was a higher figure for the outside counsel.
Right, right. And that was denied by the budget committee.
I believe it was reduced.
Back to its flat level.
Yeah. Correct.
Because we weren't given anything for an explanation. You recall that was the great discussion about whether we should fund secret programs. But I do see that you're over this year slightly in that line item.
That's correct. This is
that's as of September, so we still have 3 months more to go.
Indeed.
So I'm a little concerned about that. Are we going to be seeing still more overages there in your expectation?
Well, actually, of course, that is already over.
Right.
And that's counterbalanced in a major way by other lines which are significantly under.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And in terms of litigation we have to face, this is not necessarily litigation that we bring ourselves, but it's brought against us, and so
right.
you basically have to make judgments, as I have for many years, about what's needed to cover them with outside personnel.
Right, and I'm just concerned that I see this number going over, and I realize that you have space elsewhere in your budget to mm-hmm. cover it, but still I'd like to see line items, you know, mm-hmm. with actuals pretty well lined up as much as possible.
Okay. Well, in past, actually, that... in some years it's significantly under, and in some years it's over. It's really a function of what we're looking at a given time.
Mm-hmm.
So the best I can do on something like that is a forecast.
We could put a crystal ball in Mark's budget.
Well, I'm not trying to put a crystal ball. I'm trying to shed light on the issue.
Right. Okay.
You got a $25,000 line item from last year on this, and he's requesting $30,000. And the Board of Selectmen also threw holy water on that $30,000, and now we're about to do likewise.
Okay.
Is that going to be enough for sure? Best as you can tell?
As best I can tell at this moment, yes.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, any further questions for counsel? Sonny?
Yeah, it was one of the cases of Quarian. It's just settled because
not,
of a recall in the newspapers after you fought with them. They billed that they went to the Public Utilities Commission, added their legal costs. So
Well, no, actually, no. What you're referring to there has to do with their efforts to change their billing from in advance to in arrears, and they were changing along the way some other aspects of it. And no, ultimately, we fought them to a lot better than that. And unlike many other cases, they were not allowed to charge their legal fees to the customers.
Okay, further questions for council? Okay, we're seeing a bottom line for request for 2017 of $176,182, an increase of 1.33%. In favor of bringing that forward?
To final review, right?
To the final review. Okay. Unanimous. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much.
Planning. All right. How about our nice planning office? What happened to Kevin?
He's building.
Oh, that's true. Sorry about that.
It comes after planning.
Okay, we'll do Jason and then.
Apparently, I'm after planning.
You're next. Sorry about
logically
that.
Logically speaking.
Sorry about that. Well,
you want to use logic.
All that good stuff.
You have to plan before you can build.
Okay, Jason. All right. Jason Bichon, the planner, and it's a brown tab, and planning board is looking for $150,169 for 2017.
So moved.
Mr. Pluff is moving. Mr. Henderson is seconding. Okay.
Okay, so for the planning office, there is, or planning board, I should say, there's three changes to our budget for 2017. Under regular wages this year, it has been included a 3% increase for both the town planner and office manager positions. Mm-hmm. I will also say that our office manager, Lori Olivier, does a great job, and we're very fortunate to have her. So I think that would be well deserved. Also, under contracted services and dues, you'll note that number is up by $5,000 to $21,640 is being requested. The reason for that $5,000 increase is for grants that we pursue a lot. We're getting very assertive and pursuing a variety of grant projects. A lot of those require matching funds, and those funds need to be readily available, and we want to have that money available to pursue those variety of opportunities. We have one that we're pursuing this fall for architectural and site design guidelines that will be coming out of that for 2016.
Good.
Also, under the other item was under
replacement equipment.
We've added some money to cover for a replacement copier in the building department, covering 40% of that cost, $2,000 in total from the planning board. That we rely on that extensively for our copying and other and scanning and purposes like that to keep the office running smoothly. And the one that's there right now is really in rough shape, so it needs to be replaced. Aside from those three items, we don't have any changes. And I would entertain any questions that the committee may have.
Yeah, that machine takes a lot of heavy use.
Oh, big time.
A lot of it. This little branch, sir.
That printer you're talking about, is that the big one that you can see through the window?
No, it's in the building department. The copier and scanner and
okay. Because the thing I'm thinking of, I think you just bought it last year, maybe the year before.
No, a few years. I got here.
Large thing with a big cylinder on it.
Yeah, the large format Canon printer, yeah.
Okay, so. But this is a different one.
This is different, yes, in the building department. And we're sharing with 40% planning, 40% building, as Kevin will explain,
okay.
And then 10% conservation, 10% zoning. So
and you actually,
the cost
you're actually
based
going
on
out
usage.
For,
yeah.
You won't buy a printer. You don't lease it or anything
We'd be
that.
Buying a refurbished machine.
Okay, I see. Thank
and we
you.
Have a quote for that as well.
Thank you very much.
And you notice on this that the default budget is consistent with the 2016 budget. So we're seeing kind of up and down here. Further questions for the planner? Seeing none, are you?
Yes.
I have questions. So we have $21,640 set aside for potential grant money. Is that what I understand?
Well, that's $5,000 of that additional from the previous. A few thousand dollars would be for that from 2016 we've used for that purpose. The rest of that Those funds come to pay the Rocky Run Planning Commission for the dues each year. 2017 dues, I believe, are $12,400. And then we also have our annual maintenance of our GIS, which is $400, which is very useful to our office. So in addition to those items, it's the grants and for any sort of planning projects that we need to provide funds
for. So this $5,000 increase for potential grants is a new concept in our town budget, right?
No, because we've used that money for matching funds in the past, and we will be using it this year, as I noted, for architectural and site design.
I don't recall actually plugging in a number in there for potential grants in the past.
The board had asked.
Is my memory flawed?
The board had asked to include the additional $5,000 because we've been pursuing so many.
Right, but it hadn't been there previously, in previous years.
It had been used for that purpose. I mean,
it wasn't set aside specifically for that purpose as it is this year.
Right. I guess you could.
So that's kind of a new thing.
I guess you could say that.
Yeah, okay. Okay. Also, you've got a 3% wage increases.
That's correct.
For everyone in office.
For each of the positions that the board had asked for that.
This budget also covers the expenses of the planning board itself?
Planning board, planning office, yeah.
Okay, and should note that the planning board, was there seven members there?
Correct.
Seven members on the planning board.
And alternates, of course.
And what, three alternates?
Yes.
Yeah. So seven members of the planning board who meet at least twice a month, it seems.
Correct.
And they spend many hours, and they get a whopping zero pay, much like this committee does.
Yeah. Okay.
And they work really hard.
Yeah. Further questions for...
But there's no consideration here for that.
Right.
The scanner that you use at the billing department is a concern with me being in your budget. I'll address that when I talk to Kevin. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay, further questions, Brian?
I have a big problem with this matching grant. Where did this money, where do we have a grant in sight?
You applied for
it. Well, the thing is that you don't know, you can't forecast what grant projects and opportunities are going to come up for the year 2017. Mm-hmm. There might be a project, like I cited, the architectural and site design guidelines. We didn't see that at the beginning of 2016. That opportunity came along. It required $3,500 in matching funds that we are providing for that purpose under that line item. Yeah. If more of those opportunities come in 2017, we'll have the funds available to do that. If we don't have those funds, we may not be able to pursue those projects. That's the concern.
And otherwise, the money is just going to sit there.
If nothing comes along, then that money would not be used, but we're hopeful that something would come along.
And we have nothing in plan for a grant?
It's not 2017 yet, Brian.
Yeah. No, I understand that, but I mean...
Well, I don't know what's coming up next
we're
year.
We're just taking money, taking $5,000.
Well, I think
say, here you go.
It won't be spent unless he needs the matching funds.
But it will be taken from the taxpayers.
Right.
I think the board's concern was that, you know, right now, basically, with $16,640, really, we only have $3,000-$4,000 to work with for additional matching funds. That may not be enough. I mean, for example, that's enough for one grant project this year. If we had two and required matching funds, we wouldn't have enough funds available in that.
These are federal grants you're talking about, right?
They could be state grants.
Most likely federal grants.
They could be federal grants. They could be state grants. They could be
they could be any kind of grants. But generally speaking,
mission to the state's offices.
Which derives its money from the Fed's grants, right?
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So it's all sourced out of the Fed grant money. And I'm sure our senators and representatives are occasionally helpful in securing those grants, correct?
Okay.
But it's unfortunate now that we have we now have a Republican president next year.
Okay, Mr.
And we have no Republican senators, no Republican representatives to help us. So why would we be thinking that we're more likely to get grants next year than we have in previous years?
Mr. Jones, thank you. All right.
I asked a question, Madam Chair. I'd like the gentleman to have an opportunity to answer me.
A statement,
I asked a question.
Yes,
but I had the floor.
Done. All right.
And could you just explain what is refurbished printer?
In other words, not brand new, you know, brought up to like new condition by the printer copier company.
By a
the servicing company,
yes. Yeah. And okay. A new machine might cost three times what a refurbished one.
Okay.
That's what I was getting at. Okay,
exactly.
Great.
Good.
Thank you.
In favor of the motion for the planning and zoning budget for 2017, $150,169. Okay. Bridle, Barnes, Kravitz, Henderson, Plouffe, LaBranche, Ladd.
How about a name tag next?
Augustine and Woolsey. Opposed, Pierce, Lapham, and Jones. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Kevin, sorry about that. I promoted you to planning, but we've got you back in building inspection.
Yep, nice to see you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Jason.
Hi, Kevin.
Good evening. How are you?
I'm well. How are you?
Good, thank you.
Good. We've got a lot to go through tonight, so we really need to keep it to an even keel here.
Yes,
okay, building and code is a green tab. And Mr. Schultz is looking for 2017. 200. Your request was 221,517. The selectmen added, what did they add, Kevin?
There were some
4,000
adjustments made to wages and salaries and gasoline. And those are the only two items really that were adjusted.
Okay.
So the increase that you see, the 3.82 increase.
So you asked 221,517, and the but as we're working from the Board of Selectmen's figure 225,336.
I'll move that.
Mr. LaBranche so moves. Mr. Henderson seconds. And I will note on this that the gasoline is not as shocking in this budget for some reason. I don't know what the reason is.
And also the default budget salaries is regular wages is incorrect.
Yes, the default budget is different than the actual budget. Okay, Kevin, we have a motion for 225,336. Talk to us.
Yeah, and basically what those are, again, is a couple of line items that had adjustments, whether contractually required or merit raise. That's wages and salaries. And then the gasoline adjustment that you do see.
Great.
And those are the only two items. Other than that, pretty much everything is flat.
Excellent.
Consistent and pretty much right on target. The only big item that made that jump there that you're going to see is replacement equipment, and Jason was just talking about that earlier.
That's the other half of it.
Well, it's the other 40%.
Yeah.
Correct. We have a large copying machine that does several things for us, you know, legal, letter, 11 by 17 copies. Right. It also scans, it also emails.
It takes a tremendous beating.
And it takes a large beating because it's the building department, it's the planning department and the planning board, it's the conservation and the conservation commission, and it's the zoning board. So it's shared by four different, two departments, two commissions. It gets a lot of use. And right now, the one we have is, it's long overdue and it's been, you know, constantly being worked on. I went to use it today, and two of the three things that it's designed to do weren't working.
That's why I saw you
so
upstairs.
So it could make me a copy, but I couldn't scan, I couldn't email. And
that's why I saw you upstairs when I was fighting.
That's what I was doing.
Copier.
Exactly.
Okay, questions for the
question
inspector.
Yeah, I'm curious, since the copy gets such a workout, why not lease it and then you get the service?
Well, we have a service.
You have a service contract, but I mean, you're still trying to work your own equipment. With a lease, you have new equipment.
I have no idea. This is the way we decided to go. We got some estimates through the Paul helped us because he works, Paul in IT. And we got a estimated cost for a reconditioned, nice unit.
Yeah.
That'll give us several more years down the road of around $5,000, somewhere around there.
Good.
That's not carved in stone. It could be less, but.
Okay, Mr. LaBranche has a question.
It's more of a comment, Kevin. I just want to say that considering all the building that's been going on in this town these last several years, you and your department do an excellent, excellent job. Thank you very much.
Yeah. Well, I appreciate that, and I got a great team.
Yes,
okay, further questions for the building inspector. Tim?
Kevin, you got a raise in here?
I did.
How much?
I think it was 5%.
5%?
I did.
The copier, scanner, do you have an error in
you want to call it. as I recall, this was an item that we purchased just a few years ago, right? I remember supporting it.
No, the one you're thinking of is the one that they were talking about out in the lobby,
yeah.
The larger,
the big one.
That makes the blueprints and scans.
Okay.
No, negative. The copier that's in my office has been there, I got to say, 6 years, yeah. Maybe more.
This one that I was referring to just a moment ago, do you know who uses that?
Yeah, several departments. We use it sometimes when we're making copies of larger plans.
Mm-hmm.
We have a system now in place where we are scanning and scanning all of our records online so they're accessible, and we can slowly but surely get rid of a lot of paper files and that.
Just that whole back room back there.
Which I think I took you for a tour there, I think, one day. Yeah, exactly. So we use that for scanning as well.
So you're digitizing all the documents, and that's what that scanner is primarily used for, is digitizing the historical documents? Mostly.
I don't know if it's primary for that, but it's definitely a big part of it.
And if this one you have presently in your office, if that were to break down, you would use this one here?
But the one that we use in my office, that's more geared up for bigger jobs.
Right.
For bigger jobs. Mm-hmm. The one we use in my office, like today, I couldn't use a couple of things. I went upstairs and I used, like, the finance departments and the town managers and the one that they use upstairs.
Okay.
So the planning department plan on using this, right?
Yes, sir.
Another department whose name escapes me. Right?
The Conservation Commission. And the Zoning Board of Adjustment.
And the ZBA.
Yes, sir.
All of those are going to be sharing this
copy
scanner.
Okay. Tim, all set?
No.
Well, we've got to move.
All right. We have to have speed, not quality. I understand. So I'm wondering, you know, given that you have these, this is a small device, the other one's a larger device.
Smaller device, yeah.
Smaller device. And why isn't planning having its own? Do they not have the physical space for it, or, you know?
Well, I can tell you that could be part of the reason. We are in tight quarters, and I know you've been in the planning office, and I believe you've been through my office. I mean, as it is right now, we're sitting on top of each other.
I mean, the total cost of this unit is what? Because it's broken up all over the places.
We got an estimate from, like I said, Paul, in the IT department, that a good, reliable reconditioned unit would be somewhere around $5,000.
So that's
the number we ran with.
Okay, $5,000. So probably, possibly, we could throw another $5,000 and get a second printer and have a backup device and less crowd in your ear, because you're not actually metering. You're using this, right?
Enough. Gentlemen.
I don't meter it, no.
There's no metering mechanism in place for it, right? So you don't know which department is driving.
Absolutely
costs.
Not. Okay. Absolutely not.
Okay, you ready for the vote on the motion for the building and code inspection, $225,336 for 2017?
Kevin, no, it's not. I'll be supporting you, but I will not support a bumps rush. I vote no.
Okay, Mr. Jones is voting against. The rest of the board is.
You understand, right, Kevin?
I'm hearing you, sir.
Okay. All right, great, Kevin. Thank you so much.
Thank you, guys. Thank you very, very much.
Library, Amanda, come and be friends.
I'm sorry, Jim. Do you want to
did I miss something?
Zoning.
No.
What? ZBA.
Zoning Board of Adjustments budget?
We did zoning and planning together.
Oh, you did that with planning?
No.
I thought we did zoning and planning together. Wait a minute.
Not part of zoning.
Well, Kevin, sit down. Sit down again.
Hey, hi. Good evening.
Yes.
There we go.
Thanks.
Yeah, how you back? Will you support me on this one?
Zoning. I don't get the bounce right. I'll get
Our zoning board proposed for 2017 is $155,979.
I'll move.
So move.
Ms. Woosley, it's 58 tons for just the zoning.
155,979.
Oh, total planning and zoning?
Yes.
Well, I thought.
I'll move $155,979 to the final review for zoning.
You want to do zoning first, though, right? To get to that.
I thought so, yeah.
Zoning.
Zoning is 58.10.
Yeah,
we haven't done that yet.
The only one we've got.
Oh, I'm sorry. Zoning board, it's 5,000. Okay. It's 5,008. Okay, I move 5,008.10.
It says total planning and zoning.
That's total planning and zoning.
And we did planning. Kevin caught that. Thank you. $5,810.
Okay, that's what I moved.
Okay, seconded by Mr. Clough. Okay.
All right.
Part-time secretarial wages, legal expenses, supplies and expenses, replacement equipment.
And the only change in the budget is pretty much the $500 you will see there for replacement equipment, and that is the Zoning Board of Adjustments portion towards the new copying machine.
There you go.
Excellent. Easy. In favor? Do you understand this?
Okay. Why can't you vote for that?
Well, there's no opportunity to ask any questions.
Oh, on, well...
Still in favor.
In the process, Jenny, you know that.
I don't.
Still
in
favor. Okay. In favor. Well, Brian, what are you doing?
I mean...
Okay. In favor, 12. Mr. Jones is doing what?
I'm opposed.
Mr. Jones is opposed. Thank you very much
for
catching that.
But now you can go home.
Now, Library Amanda you. Cooper.
You're welcome.
You want to do the total while you're there on that page?
She already did that early.
No, we don't have to.
She wouldn't fall in any rational process.
We don't. Calm down.
Just made a mistake.
Okay, he's in a mood tonight. Library is the purple tab. We've got a lot to go through tonight. Stop.
Hurry up and do it. Hurry up and
make
a statement.
Okay, total library. 2017 request is 850.
I'm going to have to find library.
I want to make sure I have all right.
You got 856.
Amanda, is it 4550?
Thank you.
Account 4550.
Library, I found it finally.
Shelly, 856-588.
856-588. I move.
Yes. Okay, moved by Mr. LeBrun, seconded by Mr. Travis. Seconded by Mr. Henderson.
Okay.
Okay. Sonny, go ahead.
Yeah. Where's the gross budget?
Same place it always is.
Huh? Well, we go through this every year.
Yeah.
You've got
we
the,
sure
the
do.
Treasurer is here. Do you want to... Are you the treasurer?
Oh, no.
I can't hear what he's saying.
Actually, Ms. Woolsey, if I could, I'd like to introduce Bill Teschick, retired this year in April. He was our assistant director as well as the head of technical services.
Right.
That position being blended, we looked at our other full-time staff members to see who might want to have a blended position of being the assistant director as well. The first person who was selected is Stacey Mazur. She's our teen librarian and also our assistant director. That became effective.
Congratulations.
Oh, gosh. Why don't you tell us what's August?
You're lucky you came to a nice library, so that's good. Okay.
Put a number on the funds that you've got.
It does exist.
Put a number on the funds that you've got invested, your savings.
The trustees' Vanguard accounts is the number you'd like to know about?
No, the trustees' Vanguard accounts.
The balance as of October 31st was $117,474.
Okay.
And that's the trust account for the library.
It's actually not. The trustees of the trust fund hold four trusts for us, and then we also have money held by the trustees of the library. So that 117 is money held by the trustees of the library.
Excellent.
And that's actually... The other person to my left is, as a trustee, the chair, Bob Lamont.
Can I ask you to introduce the nice gentleman? I'm sorry, I couldn't...
Bob Lamont.
Okay, Mr. Lamont, thank you. Okay, so we have... Are we reading this correctly, Amanda? I'm seeing a total requested of $856,588. Okay, and we have a motion.
Yes.
Mr. LeBranch, seconded by Mr. Clough.
Can I make a comment?
Yes, sir.
It's unbelievable what you're doing there at the library, switching things up, moving things around. I mean, it's everything. Everything you're doing is fantastic.
Thank you very
much. Please,
and a lot of that is Stacey.
Work.
So,
yep. I'm going to say, Stacey's been doing an amazing job. Getting those kids reading is amazing. They're all having fun.
Fantastic job. Thank you.
I do have a question when it comes to the budget, please.
Yes. Wow,
first.
Go ahead.
Well, we have to get the social stuff done first because that's more important than doing the budget, you know.
Exactly.
Okay, back to the... There's three items here that have negative percentages on them. Health insurance, life insurance, and... was it merit pay? Those three. Can you explain why they all went down?
So Bill Teschick's retirement, after 37 years, really created a large amount of money that was not going to be needed in those areas anymore.
Mm-hmm.
The budget is not going up any significant amount, $443 only, because we were able to take that money that Bill's
departure left and transition it to other places where it was needed.
Right. Well, basically, just because one person left, it made that much difference, huh? Well,
37 years is a long time.
That's true. Well, thank you. That's all I have.
Madam Chair.
Okay, Brian.
This is more directed to the chairman. Something that I'm seeing a lot of, and I just wanted to make everyone aware of the fact that we're adding benefits.
This is a separate entity.
Now everyone's adding life insurance. Everyone's, you know, as like a bonus. And when we see some of these pay raises and what have you, remember too, they're getting paid now life insurance. They're getting paid, well, their insurance is insurance.
But this doesn't come under the town. In the town, it's all lumped together, but the library has always had its own.
Just, all I'm saying is you see this throughout the budget, and it appears to be a raise to me.
I don't believe we've added it.
Madam Chair.
Yes.
It is part of the town budget. That's why it's in the town budget.
No, but I mean it's not. It doesn't come under the selectmen and the Board of Selectmen.
Right, but it is in the town budget.
Yes, it's in a separate.
Just wanted to make sure the record was clear on that.
Separate entity. Okay, further questions or comments? You have questions for Mrs. Cooper? It is so well run, and you're doing such a great job. Okay, I'm looking at a motion for $856,588.
Yeah, all those in favor?
For the 2017 budget year. Unanimous. Thank you so much. It's nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
Mr. Lamont as well. Thank you very much, Amanda, for what you do.
You didn't even get a hard time for me today.
Continuing on small accounts, patriotic purposes.
Oh my goodness.
Well, you've got a big budget here.
I found it already.
It was close by.
At what point are you going to let me run this little thing by, Mary Louise?
I thought patriotic purposes was increasing.
Louis.
Mary Louise, when are you going to let? Well, when are we going to have this? Yeah.
It was increased.
Wait a second.
Showing the flower. Am I looking at the total flowers?
No, it was increased to $2,350.
What are you looking for?
$550 was added.
It was at the end.
Yeah, I'm looking for the increase. I don't see it.
$1,800 to $2,350.
Patriotic and flower garden.
Yeah, that blue one.
Patriotic purposes, 2,000.
Sorry. Thank you.
All right, enough. $2,350.
I move $2,350.
And seconded by Mr. Jones.
All
you understand the purpose?
Yes.
In favor?
Yeah.
Everybody wants to be patriot. What are you doing, Brian?
No.
No. Okay. Come on. I didn't see the right side. What are you guys all doing that? Okay. And Mr. Lapham said no. Woolsey is going along with that. Okay. And then the flower gardens.
$500.
Town beautification, $500.
Second.
Mr. Jones is moving. Mr. Second. LaBranche seconded. Yeah. You understand the purpose.
Yes.
A whole $500 in favor?
There we go.
You know, Tim doesn't like flowers.
Oh, I voted yes.
Oh, all right. Well, you've got to keep your hand in the air, you know. Okay, next is government buildings.
Not fast. We're going to move fast.
Well, we're trying to move. Government buildings is next. Mr. Jones made the motion, seconded by Mr. LaBranche.
Right. That was unanimous.
What's the name of it again?
Government building.
Government building.
Okay.
There it is. It's a green tab.
Yeah. Oh, I see it.
Okay, town office building.
$98,882 government building.
Oh, I'll second that.
Moved by Mr. Jones, seconded by Mr. LaBranche. Telephone, custodial services, electric, heating, fuel, water, and building maintenance. $98,882 up from this year, which is budgeted at $98,674. A 0.21% increase. In favor?
The discussion before we vote.
What?
Can we have a discussion about that before we
vote? Okay, discuss.
Okay. The default item under regular wages should not be $159,923. It should be the actual amount from the 16 budget, which is $154,607.
What are you doing?
You're in the wrong place, Mike.
Government buildings.
Building maintenance, yeah. The whole, let's see. 98,674 is this year.
Building maintenance.
And the default's showing 98,881.
Let me get over there real quick. I'm on the wrong page. Which way are you on?
Government buildings, Mike.
Oh, there they are.
It's right before.
So that's $7 higher in the default budget. In favor of the government buildings account. Michael, what are you doing?
I'm going to ask a question, if I may.
Excellent. We look forward to it.
$7. $7.
I'm curious about why the electric went up by 6%.
Wait to get your next bill.
Anybody going to answer that question for government buildings?
Chris, did you have a clue on the electric?
Went up nearly 6%.
I know, we're getting
an average. I think we costed out what we were spending this year so far and did a came up with that number based on that, I believe, is how we got this
figure. You took the 9 month or 10 month average?
So, yeah, I'm doing the math.
Okay.
And also, that'd be incorrect by putting that amount in the default budget.
Yeah, there is a $7 difference. In favor of?
Almost, it's over $1,200 difference.
Government buildings?
Yeah.
Mr. Jones, what are you doing?
I'm pondering Mr. Pierce's point.
Oh, good grief.
Well, then I guess you're abstaining.
Michael?
I'm still pondering the point, too. Nobody answered the question.
What question?
Why is it in the default incorrectly?
Well, we've flagged the default variations along the way. We will tackle the default at the end of our deliberations.
Okay.
That's the point here. There is no variation.
What?
There is no variation on that.
Yes, there is.
No.
There's an $8
budget on that electric line item, that subline item, is exactly the same as what is in the default budget. So there is no variation to discuss.
Yes, the variation is the bottom line, which is $7 more in the default than the existing budget. Okay, hands, before we all end up in a fight here, we're going for the government buildings. In favor, everyone but Mr. Pierce and Mr. Jones. MIS, Management Information Systems. Christy, you and Fred might as well come up. All right. MIS, Management Information Systems. It's a blue tab. Thank you, guys. Okay, Management Information Systems. 1,017.
No.
What?
$210,779.
I'm sorry. Thank you.
$79.
It's a good thing you're here.
Second.
$210,779.
Moved by LaBranch, seconded by Plouffe.
Excellent. Okay, that is up from $205,915 in the current year, a 2.36% increase. Questions on the Management Information Systems account?
Yes, we had a question with Regina about the quotes on the cloud to help us make this decision on this budget item tonight. You never did get back to us on that.
Yes, because the town has experienced some issues.
I sent an email to Mr. Jones earlier with response to the questions that you had submitted via the IT subcommittee. I don't know if you received that, but this is your copy of that.
You said earlier, you mean like an hour ago?
No, I mean I left work at like 4, so it was like before that, yeah. I left at 4.
I was still under the knife.
So. We do not have quotes on the cloud yet. It's not included in this budget. If we put something forward, it is going to come forward in the form of a warrant article. We're still waiting for... we haven't actually put out a quote or a request for quotes for the cloud yet.
Okay.
At this time. But we are looking into it.
But we will look forward.
It will be a warrant article.
It's not included
in this budget.
Okay. Further questions for Christy on the Management Information Systems account?
Let me follow up with a question. There's nothing about the cloud in this budget. Why are we buying stuff that the cloud might replace?
Such as?
Servers and so forth. You got replacement equipment. We don't know what's involved in that line.
For under replacement equipment?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I believe replacement equipment covers our
$2,600.
The schedule of, I think it's replacing, and it says, tells you how many servers, and it's replacing 17 PCs, and I don't know if there's any servers.
Two servers.
Two servers,
and.
Yeah. I should say the two servers, but if you go to the cloud will eliminate servers.
Well, the servers aren't all related to. I mean, we have servers for a lot of different things. The servers that are being replaced in 2017. Let's see here.
Madam Chair.
Hi, Mike. She's working on my.
She's working on responding to Mike.
Yes, I want to make a suggestion to the Chair.
Okay, well.
Just received an answer to the Budget Committee's request from two weeks ago. Apparently, I'm the only one in possession of it at the moment, and I haven't had a chance to read it yet.
All right.
So I would suggest, therefore, that we simply table this budget to a subsequent meeting.
Well, it's a small.
Otherwise, we're just going to be asking questions without the proper context.
Okay. It's a small enough budget if you guys will agree to it. We can return to it as part of our next meeting and use that as a quick
consult. We'll come back to it.
So we'll hold this.
Because I think that's very important. If you're going to be buying cloud service, that eliminates servers. You can eliminate all your servers if you play a game.
You can save it, Mike, for the subsequent meeting.
I understand.
Christine, I understand you haven't sent this to me.
Wait. Correct.
All right, okay. I will send this.
No, I believe it went to Mary Louise also, to the chair.
I will see to all the Budget Committee receives this response.
Okay, thank you. I think I got an email from you on it. Mr. Pluff is moving to table this account.
Second.
And Mr. LeBranch seconded.
To table.
Yes, that's just
and
what
we'll take this up at our next meeting. Okay. We should have the answers
by
then.
Vote. Do we need a vote on that?
Vote on table.
Can you tell me again who made this motion?
Mr. Pluff and Mr. LeBranch seconded.
That's a vote on.
Yes. We're getting to it. Okay, in favor of tabling. We're not going to fuss over this all night. Okay. What are you doing, Brian? Thank you. Mm. Unanimous. Okay, next I have municipal insurance.
Very good. Very good.
There it is. Okay, for 2017, the request is for...
Wait a minute, I haven't found it yet. Where the heck is it?
$3 million.
Wait a minute, where is it?
Purple.
Well, it's purple tab, and it's near the front.
$3,838,501 for municipal insurance.
I will second that. Seconded by Mr. LeBranch.
Final review.
2.43% increase. It includes liability and general insurance, health insurance, life insurance, unemployment, workers' comp, and NHMA dues. And notice the health insurance, life insurance, etc. does not include the library. This is all other employees. Okay, questions for Christy on the municipal insurance? Mike, go ahead.
Yes, I was looking at your health insurance, 2965099.
Yeah.
And we went through the same little thing last year, mm-hmm. where you've taken the obviously come up with some magic scheme to come up with that 29. When I did the prorating, I had come up with 27-ish, okay? 2.7 something. I just wondered how you come up with the 2.9. What is your approach for that one?
My approach is I took the October bill for health insurance.
Mm-hmm.
I looked at the plan that all of the employees are on currently.
Mm-hmm.
I know of one change for sure next year, so I included that change.
Okay.
In any vacant positions or at fire, they're in the process of hiring some positions. I always put those in as a two-person, if I don't know.
Sure.
So vacant positions were put in at two-person. I took all of those plans as they were on October, for the October bill, and then I added the 6.7%, which was the increase across the board to all the plans this year, which made it simple because of the fact that usually the increase fluctuates between plans, but all the plans had the same increase. So I added 6.7% to that and included the dental and the stipends that are issued to employees who do not have the health insurance coverage, and that's how I derived that number.
Okay, okay.
So it was no magic.
Okay. No, I know that you used a different approach last year than I did, and we had a little back and forth on it. Well, I didn't say my way was right, did I? I just said we did it differently. Okay, that answers my question. Thank
okay,
you.
Okay, further questions of Christy on the
6. Whatever percent comes
muni from. Insurance.
The 6.7% was the increase that was issued from Health Trust. We actually have the, sometimes when we come to the budget committee, we don't have the increase yet, but we do.
Okay.
And it was 6.7, like I said, across all of the plans, whereas in previous years, it's been like 7.3 here and 9.6 there, but it was 6.7 across the board, and no increase on the dental.
Good.
Okay. I assume we get quotes from elsewhere as well, right? Yes? No?
We do not have quotes from elsewhere on health insurance, no.
Life just insurance is up 12.46%. I'm aware of one part-time employee having been given life insurance benefits. Is this 12.46% a reflection of others getting life insurance benefits that were not previously getting life insurance benefits?
No, this 12.46%, it includes the part-timer that you were speaking of, and then it also, in the police union contract, there is a provision in there for their police specials, the line and duty death benefit.
Mm-hmm.
It hasn't been funded through the life insurance line in the past, but we have quotes in place to put that in place for January 1.
Where was it funded in the past?
It was not.
So if an officer died on duty, we would...
A special officer, yes. We would had to have come up, I believe their contract reads $40,000 worth of coverage.
Right, so we would have to pull out $40,000 out of surplus or out of the operating budget.
Correct.
Somewhere.
Right. And we've received a quote, I think it was for...
Now we're incorporating that as an insurance policy, correct?
Correct.
Thank you. That answers my question.
Yeah. Don't I don't know the exact number.
Any further? Answers it fully. Thank you very much.
In years past, we had a fire chief die, and there was not insurance, and that had to be raised at the town meeting.
I have a follow-up question on the part-timer's life insurance. How many people do we do that for the town?
The police specials?
No, the part-time employees that get life insurance. So the police specials and who else?
The assistant town manager.
That's it?
I believe so. I'd have to go look at the bill, but I think that is all. I don't think there's anyone else, but I can follow up and look at that and see. There might be some at the library. That's why I'm not sure. But that would be in their line. But if you're talking about life insurance, I don't know what their policy reads over there.
So there's just one part-timer then? The police specials are not part-timers, are they?
Well, they're considered part-timers for insurance purposes.
Yeah.
Yes.
So they get no benefits? Technically, they get no benefits. Or is that a union thing?
It's a union contract.
Okay. So we only have one non-union part-time person getting life insurance benefits.
I believe so. I'll have to review the bill, but I believe that is the case.
I'm going to formulate the question just precisely, Mike.
Thank you. I'm all set.
Okay. Are you comfortable with the motion for the 2017 budget, $3,838,501, a 2.43% increase in municipal insurance?
Yeah, all those in favor?
$3 million, I'm sorry. That's a good thing the vice chairman is sitting up here. Okay,
$3,838,501.
Can you just tell me again who made this motion?
I did.
Jones?
I think I seconded it.
Okay, in favor of moving forward with the $3,838,501 under insurance? Unanimous. Thank you. And the last thing I have here at the moment is emergency management, and then we'll have to go through.
I move the whopping total of $1,000 for emergency management. Can I get a second, Mr. LaBranche? Thank you.
Yeah, I'll second that.
All those in favor?
Wait, the chair has to ask for the vote.
Oh, I didn't know she didn't make that rule.
Are you ready to vote on emergency management? In favor? Yes. Unanimous.
There you go.
Okay, now we're going to have to go back to the executive section. We've done the Board of Selectmen and we've done the trustees of the trust funds. Mr. Jones, since you're in a congenial mood, do you want to move the budget committee line $5,150?
So moved to the final review. Yeah.
Seconded by Mr. LaBranche.
Yes.
You understand the intent. In favor?
Wait.
What?
I want to make a comment. If we're going to
Are we going to change the...
No, there should be sufficient money in what we have here now.
Well, I have a comment.
Yes.
I think this budget needs to be reworked. I don't think we're in the mood tonight to do so. But I expect we should put aside some time, at least at final review, if not sooner, to correct this budget, which I think is an error.
Well, let's do it.
Correct now. What?
I understand from someone whispering in my ear that we granted a per meeting increase in the secretarial services for one.
Yes, 25.
That has not been calculated. I also understand that, you know, we have been now for 2 years in a row getting training from NHMA, which has negated the need to spend the $300 in training costs that we had been budgeting historically, which potentially could be eliminated.
Mm-hmm.
These things need to be discussed. We need to, you know, look at our budget as frugally as we look at others.
We'll have a chance to make adjustments.
I'm suggesting that, you know, no one's in the mood to do that tonight because we're all going to enjoy the bum's rush, but we ought to set aside some time in a future meeting to do so. That's my comment.
We can do that on the final review if
you wish.
Thank
you, Madam Chair.
In favor of moving forward with the Budget Committee's figure? Nope.
Yes.
Yeah, all right. Now, Town Manager. Regular wages, part-time wages, et cetera, for the town manager and his office. A 5.91% increase. The request is $288,487. Moved by Mr. LaBranche, seconded by Mr. Henderson. Okay, Fred, there you go.
Thank you, ma'am.
The only real increase that I see is in the regular wages.
That's correct. There are no increases at all other than that. That's what the selectmen voted to do. So
I did pass out a sheet initially that showed the raises that were granted effective April 1st of this year. So you have the list. And I think Christy brought in an additional list. So you should have all of that in the mess of paperwork that was handed out to you. Okay, questions on the town manager's account? Appearing to be none.
I do have one question now that you mentioned it. I noticed that the town manager's salary is going to increase, and the default appears to be right from what I've heard. But my question is this coming, are these raises going to, all people also going to get raises out of the merit line item?
No.
Not those positions are not included on the merit line.
They're not included.
The town manager and the assistant town manager are not included on the merit line.
So, well, is that the only people who are not in it?
For non-union, no.
You have the merit raise list.
The town clerk, the tax collector,
conservation.
All those ones that you've already discussed tonight that were actually had increases in their budget of like 2 and 3%, I think.
Yeah.
Those are not included on the merit line. Nor is the town manager or the assistant town manager. That is why the board chose. It's my understanding. That's why the board of selectmen chose to include an increase in this budget that you were just speaking of, Mike.
Right.
Thank you.
Find your list that I passed out because it's.
Well, that doesn't tell him, that doesn't answer his question.
No. Well, it shows that the town manager is not included on that raise list and so forth. Okay, are you ready for the vote on the town manager's budget?
No.
No. Tim? Wait a minute. I'll get you in a minute, Dave.
I'm not sure when it's ever going to be topical, Christopher, but the merit pay was brought up, and I am confused at how that is being utilized. I have been for some years. Remember, Jenny, a few years ago, we had quite a go around the topic of merit pay as a concept,
right?
In the budget, and things have, in my opinion, since a conversation we had at a budget committee meeting, the situation is exacerbated in terms of confusion. If you watch the recent Board of Selectmen's meeting, they targeted a number of pay raises for the 2017 budget. Some or none of them actually went into the merit pay line, right? And so there is the additional cloud of confusion, to cite a famous song from the 60s.
You're dating yourself.
I'm getting old enough where I don't give a damn, Fred.
Yeah, okay.
So I'm hopeful that the Budget Committee Chair and the Budget Committee members and myself would be amenable to giving us a separate discussion on just what is and is not and why it is or is not in the merit pay and why we should continue to sustain the merit pay line item when it's being used as it is.
The merit pay line item does not include the manager.
Like I said, there's confusion over that for me, and I'd like to get clarification on that, and I'm sure it wouldn't be fair to ask for that clarification at this moment. But it's another thing we need to deal with when we're having a meeting where the bums rush is not.
But I purposely passed out what I had.
Yeah, but that doesn't answer my question, nor did that answer Mr. Pierce's question. And I'm
well, it should answer, the question.
Mine and Mr. Pierce's question, as well as Ginny's yet to be asked question.
It should answer the question on who is eligible.
I'm trying to go fast, Madam Chair.
Mr. Jones, it should answer the question on who is eligible for the merit raises. And you have the list. I went to the trouble of duplicating it for you.
It does not, Madam Chair. As I said, there were targeted pay raises put in by the Board of Selectmen. Some of them went into the merit line item. Yet the merit line item is supposed to be for, like, a not individuals, but for a group. At least that's what it was previously. And now some of that money is being allegedly targeted, but the target is not specified in the merit line item, thus giving rise to the confusion.
The positions that are eligible for the merit increases.
I didn't ask that question.
Well, I don't know where you're coming from at this point in time.
I would like for Christy to come back and give us, when she is best prepared to do so, give us an explanation on those points that I raised. You understand what I'm saying, right, Christy?
Right, and in the budget, when you get to personnel administration, it's saying
that might be the ideal time. So when you're back then,
right,
be prepared. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Thank you, Madam Chair.
Are we ready for the vote?
No.
On the town manager? No. Oh, I'm sorry, Dave, yes.
My question is, and it's to you, 6.44 seems to be high to me.
Mm-hmm.
I don't have enough detail to comprehend it. When I look at some of these raises here, they're in the 2% range, and this is 6.4, which seems to be high in today's world of inflation, which is 1.5% per year. Do we have any more detail under the wages on who got what and why?
If you look at the next page, it's showing under regular wages that the increase is by the Board of Selectmen, and it reflects a 3% increase for the town manager and the assistant town manager. So that accounts for the 6. The 0.44, I think, takes into consideration the increases that were given in 16, I'm sorry, in this
current. So it was the Board of Selectmen that voted the raise.
You're talking...
The town manager and the assistant town manager. Right.
They put 3% in the 17 budget.
Right.
And that accounts for 6 of the 6.44 that you're referring to. The other 0.44, my guess, would be related to the...
if each person got 3%, how would that increase it by 6.4? Wouldn't it just increase it by 3.0? Am I not doing the math right?
Well, they had increases in 2016.
Mm-hmm.
So this is a double hit?
Yeah.
I'm sorry?
Mm-hmm. If not triple.
In 16, the
16 budget already included the raises
that
were...
This was in addition
to... No.
Okay, rescue us, Fred.
For years, I've been asking the Board of Selectmen to put in the budget for the coming year an estimate of the amount of raises or the amount of money they wish to have for raises.
Right.
And for years, the Selectmen have refused to do it. This year, they've done it, okay? But what they have done in years past is they have done an evaluation, which sometimes takes 2 or 3 months. It's very extensive. It's very exhaustive. And then they come back and they indicate what they're going to give for a raise to the manager and the assistant manager.
Mm-hmm.
And that is taken out of the existing budget. And that's why you're confused, because there's no set amount set in the budget for that. They just declare it and take it. And we've changed that process this year, so there is a set amount within this line item for up to a 3% raise for the manager and the assistant manager if Selectmen wish to give it in 2017.
Right.
So you didn't give them any other raise for 2016?
Yes, they did give raises.
But not out of the merit.
Not out of the merit.
None of that comes out of merit. It all comes out of the bottom line.
Answer your question. That answers Mr. Marr's question, because
it was a broad-based, 3% raise this year in July? Was that broad-based?
No.
Effective April 1st.
It was all the raises that the Selectmen gave were effective April 1st of 2016.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Okay, that is the way the system has always been worked.
When they voted, it was for all non-union employees in
with
July.
With a few exceptions.
in July.
Yeah, they waited till July.
Was it a 3% raise?
Two.
No,
no,
it was two.
No, it was two.
So 2% raise for everybody that was non-union.
Except
whoever we want to accept, I guess. And then we targeted them later on, like yourself.
That is correct, yeah.
So Fred got a 6% raise at the last meeting.
The assistant manager.
Retroactive to April Fool's Day.
Mm-hmm. Right? Yeah.
And the top manager got a 3% raise.
Assistant,
retroactive to April Fool's Day. And those numbers are part of the skewing that occurs when you compare last year's budget to this year's budget, actuals and so forth. You have to kind of unpack all that, which nobody ever does.
Then they put 3% in for 2017,
right,
which we've discussed with them. We said that's the way to do it. Have the money there. If you wish to give it, you give it. If you don't wish to give it, it's not given, it goes to surplus.
You note that the Board of Selectmen, which granted the 6% raise to Fred and 3% raise to the assistant town manager, voted 3-2 on that. There were two that were objecting to the process. And at a subsequent meeting, the Board of Selectmen created a subcommittee to do a wage analysis, a broad-based wage analysis, essentially.
For the whole town?
Whole town, including me.
Yeah.
Yes, as a matter of fact. Okay.
Well, as was pointed out earlier, 3% this year and then 3% next year, all of a sudden is like 6% plus.
Yeah,
you keep this up and you go 5 years, you get a 20% raise.
Well, the reason why.
I'm underestimating by design.
Okay, pay attention.
The reason the selectmen did that was because, in their opinion, the wages that are being paid, for instance, I'm the lowest paid manager in this end of the state, okay? If you look at the other towns, which are much smaller than this and have much less to manage, okay, their wages are in the $125,000 to $145,000 range.
Hmm.
We're at $114,000.
Mm-hmm.
Which is interesting, but how many of those towns actually have an assistant town manager?
Several.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm not aware of any of them.
In fact,
totally ignorant on that.
Seabrook gets paid, their manager gets paid more than the manager in Portsmouth.
Yeah.
But Seabrook doesn't have an assistant town manager. They
have
an assistant town manager.
Ginny has a question. Ginny,
all right, I'm confused. So when you got your budget that was approved in March,
right,
that didn't have any raises for these people?
They never put any in, no.
Just for the
non-union employees, with the exception of the manager and the assistant manager.
So how did some other departments in here get 5% raises as well?
They put it in and you approved it at the budget last year, okay? They came in, for instance, conservation, planning, they have the right to hire employees and pay them outside the town pay system, the tax collector, the town clerk, the treasurer, all those are separate.
Okay.
So when they put a raise in and it gets approved within the general budget of that particular department,
and they can have
they get that raise.
Yep.
So
okay, but nobody put one in for you two. So now
that's correct.
Okay. So how did all these people get all this? Was none of these people on this list get approved for a raise last year?
There was a merit pay.
It did. There's a merit
line.
There's a merit
this
line.
Is our, yeah.
In the finance department.
Yeah.
Okay.
Personnel.
And under personnel.
Yeah.
And there's 2% in there for every single employee that is a non-union employee, with excluding the exceptions.
Then that's not a merit raise. That's a 2% raise.
Well.
Right.
They call it a merit. That's what it's always been. That's just the title of the account.
Distributed that over the last couple of years.
And there have been several years where they did not grant the entire 2%.
Right.
Okay.
Or didn't give to certain people or certain positions.
Okay.
And the reason April 1st is the date is because all of the union contracts end on March 31st in a given year.
Right.
So it was logical to, if you're going to do, either you have your collective bargaining rolling over on April 1st, and concurrently, you want to kind of keep the non-union employees in the same type of cycle.
So this merit raise is not tied into any performance evaluation?
Not to this
point. All of the non-union employees are evaluated. They are all evaluated.
Before they get the merit raise?
Yes, that's correct.
Yes, the point of confusion is the same we had several years ago. While they're all maybe individually evaluated, they're all giving exactly the same 2%.
They don't all get it.
Not always.
No. Well, this
Sometimes
year it was.
They don't. This year they did.
And last year?
Right.
No, I don't
know.
No,
they did not last year all get 2%.
Okay, so, ladies and gentlemen.
It was the same number, that's the point.
Tim.
And the year previous to that, everyone got the same number, except the town planner, who got nothing.
Because it's calculated in total.
Yeah, I understand.
Okay.
So everyone's equally meritorious. That's what Jenny and I were
okay,
discussing.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we have to be out of here by 10 o'clock.
The well, we got to, you know, quick, to make mistakes and hurry
yes,
up.
Yes, we've already lost three meetings because we got the budget late. Okay. I want to vote on the town manager.
Yes.
288,487. In favor?
Who made the motion?
Who made the motion?
It.
Did
I
you?
Second.
Okay.
I made it, Steve Henderson.
LaBranch and Henderson.
It was 310,937,
okay,
right?
Yeah.
In favor of the manager's account for 2017. Okay. Bridal, Barnes, Kravitz, Henderson, Woolsey, Pluff, LaBranch, Ladd, and Augustine. And every show your hands for not approving. Okay, Maurer and Jones and Lapham and Pierce. Okay. Now, next.
Okay.
So we've got to keep moving here. We've done the town. We did election. Okay, finance, Christy, that's you. Finance department, I'm showing $383,411.
I'll move that. Second.
Seconded by Mr. Pluff. A 4.91% increase.
Is that the right number, Christy?
$383,411.
No, it's the finance department.
We'll do the audit services in a minute, separately.
The $39,300 for...
$39,300.
I'm looking
for postage.
Now, what's the color?
The default line should not be the same as what's requested, and the $37,000 for the next line down, the bank service.
You're right. Charge. The default budget is out of kilter there, but we're not going to spend our lives on the default budget. Okay.
I'm pointing it out to Christy.
Christy, do you want to?
Finance.
Do you want to say anything to your budget or?
Sure, I'll say something about budget. There's an increase in regular wages and part-time wages. The big increase there is related to FMLA leave of an employee that I know I'm going to have next year, and so I have put in to have coverage so that we can have someone in that position when the individual is out. The postage has gone up. The tax collector... when she puts her liens on property now, she used to pay the vendor who processes the liens the postage, and now it has to be paid out of the postage line, so that line increased. And bank service charges is increased just based on the actuals that we've been spending there. And that's about it.
I have a question about the family leave item.
Yes.
Why would that go up? Because there's nothing that family leave act says you have to pay it.
You have to pay the employee if they have time on the books. And this is the additional money that's in the budget is to have coverage so I can have someone in the office to do that person's job when they are out.
I understand, but if the person takes leave and you don't pay them, then...
But I will be paying the person if they have leave on the books. They have sick and vacation time on the books, and under FMLA, you are allowed to exhaust all of your sick and vacation time, so the individual has time on the books, so I will be paying the individual who is out.
So
and
she
then
has,
I would like to pay for someone to cover the time when that person is out.
I understand that part. So she has 10 to 12 weeks of
she does, yes.
on the books?
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. That's why it's 10 to 12, and then I'm not sure if she's going to have the whole 12. Yeah.
Okay, so you understand the intent of the motion, 383,411.
For fund for vacation and leave and stuff like that?
For the 2017 budget.
No.
Okay.
And postage. I mean, I know Mike Schwarzman and I discussed this a couple of years ago about the ability to meter which departments are using their postage. It was going up back then, and now it's going up again. And I'm wondering if you are looking into getting a metering system set up, which isn't that difficult because it's already software based, right?
Our postage procedure is software based. We do not meter it though.
Yeah.
We don't mark because not all of the departments are. The mail is not distinguishable because a lot of the departments use the same. Town envelopes stationary, but we do not meter it now.
Right now,
we have software though. On
you know, there's an old saying: you can't measure it, you can't manage it, right?
Right, but the postage is all out of this. No one else has postage in their budgets.
That's a problem space that, you know, if we could measure it, then management would be able to manage. And so I just wanted to highlight that it's something that is still kind of on my mind from years ago.
Okay, are you ready for a vote on the motion?
No, I'm not.
Well, we're not. We've got more to get through.
Well, hurry up and make mistakes then.
We're not making mistakes. What do you mean,
are
you, Stephen?
You said it's a mistake.
Vote. I'm ready to vote.
Bless your heart. Okay.
Well, if Steve's ready, then the world is. Yes. That's a certainty.
That's an excellent thought.
Come on.
Brian, how about you?
I mean.
Okay, Steve? Hands?
Mark is.
Okay. Mr. Jones is doing what?
I am adamantly opposed.
Mr. Jones is opposed, and Mr. Pierce is out of the room.
I'm opposed adamantly.
So, Mark, Mr. Pierce abstaining. Okay, moving on to. I did assessing.
Services.
What? Audit services. I'm sorry. Thank you. Okay. Audit services.
In a 3-year contract, this will be year 2 of it.
$31,650. Moved by Mr. Plouffe, seconded by Mr. LeBranch.
Yes.
You understand the intent? It is a contract. In favor? Dave, what are you doing?
I'm trying to find it.
It's right under,
under finance. It was on that same page.
Same page.
Yeah,
same
page.
Okay.
There
you
go. $31,650. It's up $150.
Mike, the audit services.
My apologies.
That's okay. I was just hoping.
Okay. Or what are you voting?
Where are the audit services?
Bottom
of the financial.
Oh, okay.
$31,000.
I'll vote for them.
Thank you. Unanimous.
Not quite.
No, you're opposed?
Yes.
Okay, I'm sorry, Mr. Jones is opposed. We've done assessing, mm-hmm. We've done the tax collector, we've done MIS,
good.
And legal.
Legal.
Personnel admin, here you go.
Okay.
Personnel admin, $3,179,510.
I'll move that number.
Second.
Okay. Employee separation costs, sick leave, buyback, compensated absence, reserve fund, merit pay, Social Security, Medicare, New Hampshire Retirement System, 401 retirement, New Hampshire Retirement System for police and fire. And I did pass out to you a copy of the new retirement system percentages, et cetera, that are going to come into effect July 1st. So you all have a copy of that.
Mm-hmm.
So you understand how the system works.
Yes.
Well, this is what we got tonight.
Yes, it's one of the pass-outs.
Well, none of us have had a chance to read it.
I know, but I passed it out to you so you can read it.
And so then I'll make a motion that we come back to this.
I second that motion. We've already asked Christine to come back with a detailed explanation about the concept of this merit pay raise line item, which is up 85.26%.
Okay, then if you want to, Brian's making a motion to hold until a subsequent meeting. We will fit that in as best we can, but you all have a copy of that.
Yep.
So you understand retirement system. Okay,
who's
moving
second,
on. Well, you want to vote in order to hold that?
Yep. You made the motion, it was seconded, so we just
go ahead and vote. Mr. Plouffe moved and Mr. LeBranch seconded to hold.
No.
Brian did.
You have to take a vote right now because Brian made a motion to
table it, and he seconded it.
And who seconded? Mr. Jones. All right. Yes. The motion to table is on the floor.
Right. We need to vote.
All right. In favor of tabling. Bob?
You want to deal with pay raises, you need to table it.
I'm against tabling it.
Oh, okay.
So I vote no.
Okay, Woolsey and LeBranch are opposed. The rest of you are in favor. All right, our next account. We've done planning and zoning. We've done government buildings and cemeteries. We've done municipal insurance,
yep.
Parking admin.
Mm-hmm.
Police and fire are next Tuesday.
Mm-hmm.
Building and code we have done. Emergency management.
It's done.
Public Works will be the 29th.
You skipped other safety services.
Other safety services. Account 4299. Hydrants, which actually went down by 2.04%.
Yeah.
Hydrants are 484196. Moved by Mr. LaBranche, seconded by Mr. Plouffe. You understand the intent. In favor of the money for hydrants?
Yes.
That's fixed with Aquarian.
I am in favor.
Well, I think that's great. Okay.
I as well.
Otherwise, street lighting is $220,018. That's up 17.46%. Traffic light repairs and electricity.
So moved.
Wait a minute. For a total of
257,228.
Okay. Moved by Tim. I'll second it.
Yes. I'm sorry. 257,228. Yeah,
okay,
you're
so
right.
I'll second that.
Excellent. Seconded by Mr. LaBranche. You understand the intent. In favor? Dave, Brian, what are we doing?
Yeah, unanimous.
No.
It is
no.
What it is. What?
No.
You're no. Opposed. Dave, what are you doing?
Opposing.
Okay. Maurer and Lapham are opposed. Everybody else is?
Madam Chairman, there's another mistake with the default budget line.
Okay, but the default budget is an issue for another time. Well, I'm flagging them as we go along.
Okay.
But this is just the bottom line, 257,228. Okay. Lifeguards, if...
Lifeguards, I move for $22,160.
Second.
Okay, seconded by Mr. LaBranche.
I have
in favor?
A question, Madam Chair.
What?
I'm not sure who to ask. Last year, we were asking the rec director. And last year, we actually increased this line item, Fred, because the perception was that we weren't able to hire lifeguards because we couldn't show them enough green, that is to say, enough money. And so we increased it, I think, something on the order of 20%.
Yep.
And we ended up with no lifeguards again.
It's still hard to
And
get
so
yeah.
I'm looking at this number, I'm saying, okay, it either needs to go up still higher, or it needs to go to zero. Yep. Or alternatively, a third possibility would be, maybe we've got to set up a fund, we can throw the money in there when we can't hire anyone, and then it'll build up until we have enough money to hire somebody. But just sitting here doing nothing just seems to be kind of a futile exercise.
Oh.
So please comment on that.
We're unable to hire people because they're not applying for the jobs.
Right.
We had one applicant this year.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know, we need at least four. And that's kind of the bottom line. The state's having the same problem. The town of Rye's having the same problem.
Yeah. Right.
The town of Northampton's having the same problem. We just have to, people are not willing to go out and do the training that's required in the Red Cross training system to get into this program. And even if we offered to pay for it, they're still not willing to do it.
Yeah.
So
if we double this amount, we'll still have an equal chance of not getting anybody.
It could very well be.
So then
the question is whether or not you want to appropriate funds and continue to try to get people instead of just posting the beaches, swim at your own risk.
Well, it seems futile that to take the money from the taxpayers and say, well, we're not getting the lifeguards and sorry, but we tried, when in fact we know in advance we're not going to get them.
Yeah. This would be the fourth year in a row that we haven't had lifeguards.
Exactly. Well, things could change next year, though.
Could very well.
We say that every year. And last year I was actively in that motion to increase it by over 20%, trying to get enough green out there to attract some people. And I'm happy to do likewise again this year, to throw more money at it in hopes that we can be first in line for the available lifeguards.
We're not going to get them.
But if we're not going to do that, doing nothing and staying where we are now seems to me to be completely futile. We got to just drop it to zero or increase it, one or the other. So that's my comment. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Do you want to put it down for a dollar?
Yeah, I'll put it down for a dollar. That way, if they can find them, they have a line item that allow them to spend the money out of the budget.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah. I guess I make a motion to move that lifeguard line to $1.
I'll second that.
Okay, we already had a motion on the table. You gentlemen withdraw.
I'm the one that moved it. I hereby remove my motion.
Okay, so you want to withdraw the motion.
Yep.
And then we're going to do...
New motion.
A new motion.
To move the $22,160 to $1.
That line to a dollar. Good.
In a second.
That would be Mr. Lapham.
Mm-hmm. Okay. In favor? Regina, what are you doing?
Opposing.
Okay. Mr. Kravitz and Mr. Lapham, you're in favor?
Yep.
Yes, okay. All right. Mrs. Barnes is declining the rest of the board committee.
Could I just make a comment?
Yes, please.
I'm not sure, Tim, you were here when Parks and Recreation, when Diana was speaking, but I thought I heard her say...
I was not.
I thought I heard her say that she was not going to
have any lifeguards next year.
She's not.
I thought I heard her say
that. She doesn't expect
it. She said it was moved from her budget.
I walked in. Yeah. I walked in.
That's what I heard.
Okay, that's what she said. We moved from her budget.
She wasn't even sure where it was.
There used to be a lifeguard line. The lifeguards used to be a line at the very end of the recreation budget, I believe. Right. I think it was right at the last line.
Yeah. Yeah.
This year we pulled it out and moved it over here as we did street lighting. Because street lighting used to be under public works. And now it's over here.
See, that's why I voted for $1, basically to defund it. Just because I thought I heard her say she wasn't going to have life.
She just said it was moved, so she didn't know who she wasn't sure who was going to be in charge.
We don't know if we will.
Stephen, I arrived at the end of her presentation. I'm the one that asked the question. Her response was that she's no longer charged with hiring anybody. It's not in her budget. And informed me that it was under other services.
Thank you.
I have been waiting like a cat.
That clarifies it.
So we're all set on the $1.
Yes.
Okay, moving over to animal control. Animal, I'm
that's
sorry.
Police,
Mrs. Barnes, you are.
No, she's not in favor. No. Opposed. Thank you.
Okay, animal control under health and human services.
That's under police.
That's under police, Mary.
That's under police.
Oh, all right.
Haven't done is debt service.
That's
service.
Right.
Okay.
Mosquito control, we have done.
Okay, we go to debt service.
Debt service.
What are we doing, tab by tab? Is that what
we do? We do conservation, welfare. I guess we got everybody else. Okay. Debt service.
Have you done animal control?
That'll come with police, and police is Tuesday night.
Okay. It's not under police, but it's the police chief who is in charge.
Right. You're right.
Just to explain it to you.
Right.
It's not under the police department, though. You're right. It's its own section at the end.
Yeah.
Okay.
The state accounts list is separate.
Now, Mr. Pierce, I think you had some comment on debt service and so
Do you want to move it first?
Yeah, well, wait 1 second here.
I move 26.
No, million. 2,476,000.
2.476549.
Yes.
$1 million.
I will
debt service to the final review.
You can move the 26 if you want. That's the whole budget.
I wasn't quite sure
how fast that
Bob Preston would do it.
Pay attention because it's getting late. Mr. LaBranche has seconded. Okay, so you've got your principal, you've got your interest, and you've got your interest on the tax anticipation borrowing. And that would be for the treasurer. Okay, so you're showing the indebtedness for 2017 and what we owe on debt, the bonds, 2,476,549, a decrease of 17.35%.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. You understand the intent?
Yes.
In favor?
Excuse me, are we going to have no discussion on this?
Well, then put your hand up if you want to discuss.
Well, you began by saying, Mr. Pierce, I believe you have something to say on this.
That's right.
You cut me off, so I said the hell with it. I'm following your rules, Madam Chairman.
Okay.
You're a good man, Mike.
That's right.
Jump in.
Good Mike.
Go ahead.
Good
okay.
Because you did have a question.
I did have some notes I made about this earlier. It's the budget's been presented as a 1.11% increase in spending. However, when you look at debt service going down by a little over $500,000, $519,749. Okay, that means that this increase in spending for 17 is actually going up to $814,957 over 16. So that's a significant change. That's 3.5. That's one of the highest dollar amounts we've had for an increase in many years, okay, going back over the records. So what I'm trying to say to everybody here is from 2008 to 14, the taxes on an average single family home went up from 5909 to 5989, 1.3 over that period of time, increase in taxes. When you look at 14 to 15 and 15 to 16, they went up 8%. Okay, Social Security went up 0.3% in the last 2 years. So we're outspending Social Security by multiple numbers there. So I think you need to look at this budget and going through it and seeing all these generous pay raises and say, where did they come up with an $814,000 increase in spending to go to 17 for the budget we're looking at compared to the one we're in right now? That's almost $1 million, folks. That's significant. The last time we had something that bad was when the voters turned down the 2004 budget, I think it was, when they asked for 22%. Mm-hmm. This is
getting outrageous too. So we have to look at that. We ought to look at these raises. We ought to take some of that stuff and chop it out. And if you don't have the nerve to do it, don't complain to me about your tax bill when you get it, because it just keeps going up and up and away. And people will say, oh, well, my taxes didn't go up much this year, but that was because we reevaluated. They brought on new properties, and the reevaluation, some of the properties got significantly increased in value. Okay? So your average tax bill probably went up significantly if you look at the average house being at a little over $400,000. So you have to keep that in mind. Your tax bill went up already before we even approve a big tax increase, a big spending project like this or a budget like this. Your taxes are going to just keep going up and up and away. If you have a 3% increase for 5 years in a row, you say, that's 15%, but when you compound it, which it is in the budget, that works out approaching 20%, something like 19 and some change. And if you look at Social Security in 5 years, that's not going to happen. If you're on a fixed retirement thing, that's not going to happen. So the only way you're ever going to keep up with this kind of spending, if you live in Hampton, is to be making more and more money every year. And not everybody does that. So that's all I wanted to say about this when we go into the debt service. Basically, what we've been given here is a $500,000 gift, if you want to say that, but they've managed to spend it in this budget, plus $295,000. So we got to really be tight when we're going through this budget with the salary increases and everything else. We just can't afford it, folks. At least I can't.
Christy, can you address that with the debt service being retired?
The debt service that has been retired?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the debt service is going down, right?
Yep, debt service is going down. We lost the recycling and the SRF refinancing payment. There's a total of $452,104.
Mm-hmm. How much was the so-called recycling?
Recycling? It's in Appendix C, I think.
And are those for those articulating on dump trucks, or are they for the barrels, or what is that?
Everything.
All of it.
It was the recycling equipment. It was from 2011, I believe.
Right. This is when you were selecting, Mr. Pierce, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. This is a bill we paid off from when you were selecting.
Yes, and the reason why the spending did go up in 13, I might add, is that's when the New Hampshire retirement system got jumped out of the supporting that system.
Mm-hmm.
That was in 13, and also it was the first year of union contracts that we hadn't had any for 6 years going into that, and it was the first full year of union contracts. So it was about $250,000 for police and $250,000 increase in fire that year. So that was a high year. It had $795,000.
Well, you know,
but this year is topping that. We don't have any of those problems this year.
From my point of view, Madam Chair, what we did was we had some years ago made an investment, if you prefer, in terms of lowering expenses relative to primarily recycling, but collection in general. Is that accurate, Fred?
Mm-hmm.
Made that investment back when you were selectman, Mr. Pierce. And it was like taking a second mortgage out in your house to remodel, so to speak. And now we've paid that off. That's the most significant payoff this year. And we sit back in our household budget and we say, oh, great, that second mortgage is now paid off.
Right.
But why is the annual budget going up
right, when
it should be going down? We should have more discretionary money to spend.
Right.
Right. And it's not there. There's actually less. And that's exactly your point, isn't it?
Yes.
Okay.
Because you think a $500,000 obligation would be significant enough to might even cause the budget to go down.
This particular item that we moved and are about to vote on, Madam Chair, is the single biggest savings in the entire budget this year, right?
Probably,
yes.
Yeah.
Okay. And it is all wiped out by other things in the budget plus some, which is Mr. Pierce's point. Now, all those things that are wiped out were probably good. We're going to look into that later, I guess. Night when we're not enjoying the bums rush.
Are we ready to vote on that?
Thank you, Madam Chair.
I don't know, because do you want, Christy, is this something you want to get back to us on, or?
Well, no.
Well, debt service is what
debt
it is.
Service
now,
is
what you're talking about.
It's been reduced.
Debt service is what it is.
Debt service is what it is.
It's been reduced. There's the new number.
In conjunction with the whole budget?
There's the number. 2,476,549.
Madam Chair, that's the number. The question, where did the savings go?
Right.
Is all over the place in the budget book.
Right.
Okay. And that's our job, is to discern it. when we're not in such a rush.
And that's why I want, why I wanted to bring it up at the first of the meeting, well, before we started being so generous with all the items going along, Madam Chairman.
So all those in favor of the motion of the debt service, please.
Wait a minute.
This reflects accurately what the current debt service for next year will be.
Exactly. Okay, that's the number. It's not
Mr. Pierce has asked a question in conjunction with the entirety of the budget because of the reduction in the debt service.
I believe he made a statement.
Obligation.
Could I make a statement as well then? Okay. The stuff that we've passed tonight so far, I have not seen $800,000 worth of spending. So perhaps it's in a different budget somewhere else. We certainly have not passed $800,000 worth of increases tonight. A few 3% increases don't amount to $800,000. So
no, we're having to get a couple hundred thousand tonight and a couple hundred thousand the next night. We'll get there.
We didn't even do $200,000 increase. So
it has to all add up somehow, Steve.
I know it does. In any case, that's the number for the debt service for next year. It's not going
to
change.
Is everyone prepared to vote?
Indeed.
On the debt service.
My favorite.
Total.
There you go.
Okay. And
could you clarify that?
Unanimous.
Would you clarify the statement for me, please? After all this talk, I'm confused.
Yes.
What are we voting on? Exactly.
We're voting on the requested amount of money to meet our debt service obligations in 2017. And that's the $2,476,549.
Okay.
It's perfunctory anyway, because even if we didn't fund it, we'd still have to pay for it by law.
Okay.
You don't actually have to vote on it.
Thank you.
We vote. We finish voting.
Are you comfortable? Everybody is in favor. Okay.
Yeah.
Now that closes us out for the evening. We have fire and police on Tuesday, and we're devoting the entire meeting on the 29th to the Department of Public Works.
There you go.
And then we have a review day. I updated your schedules for about the 10th time. And forwarded them to you. So the one dated November 9th, I believe it is, 8th or 9th, is the final schedule for the time being. We will go back to retirement when we next meet, and we held out one other thing, and we'll...
M.I.S.?
What?
M.I.S.
Management Information Systems.
One other question, Madam Chairman. You said you passed out two sheets with the applications for this year?
There's a sheet from Christie, and there was a sheet that I did that's dated April 1st.
There should be this one.
Yeah. Voter selectmen pay raises, that came from Christie.
I have that one. I don't have the
and
one.
And the other little one I passed out was from me.
I don't have the
sheet. Yeah, I've got it. Here.
Wait a minute. If I have it, I don't know where it is. I've got that one.
Okay.
Is that the same thing?
Merit pay and everything, Mike.
Okay, I got that.
Entertain a motion for adjournment.
Mr. LaBranche is prepared to make a motion.
Well, before he does, I'd like to make a comment.
Go ahead.
My apologies to the Budget Committee and the town for showing up late tonight. Mm-hmm. I had something personal pressing of greater import to me. And I'll try to be more prepared and more on time in the future. Thank you.
Okay, we appreciate that. And police and fire. Fire will come first.
Okay, so my motion is to adjourn.
At what hour?
At 9:42.
9:42 p.m. Seconded by?
Mr. Henderson.
Mr. Henderson. In favor of adjournment. Thank you to the control room.
Okay, thank you, Madam Chair.
Well, we should make a significant amount.